أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
ألف لام را تلك آيات الكتاب المبين
ألف لام را These are the verses of the clear book.
Alif Lam Ra, the third surah, consecutive surah, which is starting with these three letters, Alif Lam Ra. Surah to Yunus, Surah to Hud, before this, also began with these. And I pointed out to you, these words, these letters here are not counted as an ayah. Alif Lam Mim in Surah Al-Baqarah, Alif Lam Mim in Surah Ali Imran are counted as one ayah. Alif Lam Ra is not. But it is not based on any principle of logic, any principle of grammar, nothing of that sort. It is all taqifi. As the Prophet said, we take it. Tilka ayatul kitab al-mubin. These are the ayat of a book which is very clear, manifest.
إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا لَّعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ
Indeed, we have sent it down as an Arabic Quran that you might understand.
إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا We have sent it down as an Arabic Quran. Now, who? What is this? Pronoun, objective mood of the pronoun. The real book is there. Fi lawhim mahfuz, kitabim maknoon, fi ummul kitab ladayna al-aliyyul hakeem. Now when we have sent down it to you, we have made it a book, a Quran in Arabic language. You don't know what language is there. Allah's language, you know. Actually, we don't know. But this Had this Quran been revealed to any other nation, having another language, it would have been revealed in that language also. Torah was given in Hebrew. Injil we don't know, absolutely don't know in which language it was revealed. Because we don't find any original text of Injil in Hebrew, nor in Aramaic, nor in Syriac. And these are the only three languages which could be the original language of Injil. But no copy, no text is to be found. The earliest copy of Injil is a Greek translation. Now, Injil could not have been sent down in Greek, because Greek was not the language of the area where Hazrat Masih al-Salam lived. So it couldn't be that. It would have been Greek to them, as we say, you know, idiomatically. It's all Greek for him. But it would have been Greek for them. So actually it must have been sent either in Hebrew or in Syriac or the Aramaic language. But they don't claim to have any text in those original languages. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down, Inna ja'alnahu, we have made it Quranan Arabiyan. The Quran, Arabic Quran, La'allakum ta'qilun, so that you may understand it. Who are they, you? The people of Arabia, who were the first addressees of Quran. To them the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was al-baisatul khassa. Exclusively, special, you know, advent was for the people of Arabia.
نَحْنُ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ أَحْسَنَ الْقَصَصِ بِمَا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ بِمَا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ وَإِن كُنْتَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ لَمِنَ الْغَافِلِينَ
We relate to you, O Muhammad, the best of stories in what we have revealed to you of this Quran, although you were before it among the unaware.
نَحْنُ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ أَحْسَنَ الْقَصَصِ We narrate to you the best narrations. بِمَا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ With that, what we have sent down to you and we have revealed to you this Quran, وَإِن كُنْتَ مِن قَبْلِهِ لَمِنَ الْغَافِلِينَ. Surely, before this, you were also absolutely unaware from among the unawares. Just as your nation didn't know, you also didn't know.
إِذْ قَالَ يُوسُفُ لِأَبِيهِ يَا أَبَتِ إِنِّي رَأَيْتُ أَحَدَ عَشَرَ كَوْكَبًا وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ رَأَيْتُهُمْ لِي سَاجِدِينَ.
Of these stories mention when Joseph said to his father, O my father, indeed I have seen in a dream 11 stars and the sun and the moon. I saw them prostrating to me.
إِذْ قَالَ يُوسُفُ لِأَبِيهِ. Now who is Yusuf? Please note here, you must be knowing. Son of Yaqub, who was son of Ishaq, who was son of Ibrahim a.s. So grandson of Hazrat Ibrahim a.s. Grand-grandson, we should say. إِذْ قَالَ يُوسُفُ لِأَبِيهِ. Who is Abi? And he is Yaqub a.s. يَا أَبَتِ إِنِّي رَأَيْتُ أَحَدَ عَشَرَ كَوْكَبًا وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ رَأَيْتُهُمْ لِي سَاجِدِينَ. Oh my father, I saw in my dream, in my vision, 11 stars and the sun and the moon prostrating before me.
قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تَقْصُصْ رُؤْيَاكَ عَلَىٰ إِخْوَتِكَ فَيَكِيدُوا لَكَ كَيْدًا إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لِلْإِنسَانِ عَدُوٌ مُبِينٌ.
He said, O my son, do not relate your vision to your brothers, or they will contrive against you a plan. Indeed, Satan, to man, is a manifest enemy.
He said, the father said, O my son, dear son, don't relate this vision of yours to your brothers. There were 11 brothers of yours. Two of them, they were the youngest, Hazrat Yusuf bin Yamin, and they were from the same mother. The elder 10, you know, they were from different mothers, but they were one group. And they were all, you know, united against these two. Because being the youngest, they were more dear. They were more focused of attention of father, Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam. So they had developed a jealousy. So that was, you know, the cause of that enmity, that jealousy. قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تَخْصُصْ رُؤْيَاكَ عَلَىٰ إِخْوَتِكَ فَيَكِيدُوا لَكَ كَيْدًا. They will plot against you and devise against you a device, a plot. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لِلْإِنسَانِ عَدُوٌّ مُبِينٌ. Verily, Satan is for humans, for mankind, a very clear enemy.
وَكَذَٰلِكَ يَجْتَبِيكَ رَبُّكَ وَيُعَلِّمُكَ مِنْ تأويل الأحاديث ويتم نعمته عليك وعلى آل يعقوب كما أتمها على أبويك من قبل إبراهيم وإسحاق. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ عَلِيمٌ حَكِيمٌ.
And thus will your Lord choose you and teach you the interpretation of narratives and complete His favor upon you and upon the family of Jacob, as He completed it upon your fathers before, Abraham and Isaac. Indeed, your Lord is knowing and wise.
وَكَذَلِكَ يَجْتَبِيكَ رَبُّكَ. Now He is giving thee what was the interpretation of this dream? You will be chosen. Out of my sons, you will be chosen as Nabi. Ijtiba and istifa, these are two very closely related words. That is why we use these two words about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ahmad Mujtaba. And both have very similar, you know, connotation. To choose someone, to select someone. But there is a difference in choice and selection. But I can't go into detail. So this ijtiba and istifa is for the prophets. وَكَذَلِكَ يَجْتَبِيكَ رَبُّكَ. And this dream, you know, shows that you will be chosen by your Lord. وَيُعَلِّمُكَ مِنْ تَعْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ. And He will teach you the interpretations of all things. Ahadith, you know, you usually people think the visions and dreams. No. Hadasa means anything which happens. Hadisa, an accident. Whether it is an accident or an incident or a saying. Hadithul Rasul. Hadithullah. فَبِأَيِّ حَدِيثٍ بَعْدَهُ يُؤْمِنُونَ. This is Hadith of Allah. So all the sayings, all the statements, all the incidents, all the accidents, all the dreams, all the visions, they are all included in this word ahadith. He will teach you the interpretation and to reach to the basic thing in every statement, in every saying, in every dream, in every vision, in every imagination, etc., etc. وَيُتِمُّ نِعْمَتَهُ عَلَيْكَ وَعَلَىٰ عَلَىٰ يَعْقُوبَ. And he will perfect his blessing on you and the progeny of Yaqub. كَمَا أَتَمَّهَا عَلَىٰ أَبَوَيْكَ. As he perfected it on your forefathers min qabl, before Ibrahim wa Ishaq. That is Ibrahim and Ishaq alayhi salatu wa salam. And he didn't name himself out of humility. It was not good, you know, that he should have named himself also. Ibrahim wa Ishaq wa Yaqub. But he was himself speaking, so he omitted his name. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ عَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. Verily, your Lord is all-knowing, all-wise.
لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي يُوسُفَ وَإِخْوَتِهِ آيَاتٌ لِلسَّائِلِينَ.
Certainly were there in Joseph and his brothers signs for those who ask, such as
لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي يُوسُفَ وَإِخْوَتِهِ آيَاتٌ لِلسَّائِلِينَ. Verily, in this, you know, the story of Yusuf and his brothers are signs for those who are asking. They will see a mirror. A mirror will be presented to them because the Quraysh asked the question. Actually, those who instigated were the Jews. But to Prophet Hassan came the Quraysh. Now actually, both of them, you know, the Quraysh as well as the Jews, they had been given this mirror. You can see your picture and you can see the picture of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The role, the same role as of Yusuf is now today of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the role that was of the brothers of Yusuf is of these chieftains of Quraysh and the Jews of Medina.
إِذْ قَالُوا لَيُوسُفُ وَأَخُوهُ أَحَبُّ إِلَىٰ أَبِينَا مِنَّا وَنَحْنُ عُصْبَةٌ إِنَّ أَبَانَا لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ.
When they said, Joseph and his brother are more beloved to our father than we, while we are a clan. Indeed, our father is in clear error.
When they said, verily Yusuf, Yusuf and his brother are more dear to our father than us. Although we are a strong group. Now this word, you know, usba, strong group. We are a strong group. So actually, he should love us more. We can protect him. At any time of emergency, we can come to his help. So he should show more affection towards us. But what we see that he loves these two youngsters who can't be of any help. Inna abana lafi dalali mubin. Verily, our father seems to be in a manifest error.
اقتلوا يوسف أو اطرحوه أرضا يخل لكم وجه أبيكم وتكونوا من بعده قوما صالحين.
Kill Joseph or cast him out to another land. The countenance of your father will then be only for you, and you will be after that a righteous people.
اقتلوا يوسف أو اطرحوه أرضا يخل لكم وجه أبيكم. Now either kill Yusuf or expel him into some other land, so that the attention of your father now becomes exclusively for you. The same thing. ليثبتوك أو يقتلوك أو يخرجوك. Either they should imprison you, or you kill you, or expel you. The same thing. اقتلوا یوسف اب اطرحوہ ارض یخلو لکم وجہ ابیکم وتکونوا من بعدہ قوما صالحین. And after that you become the righteous man, you know. So this is a usual thing which our nafs, you know, tells us. Well, you know, take this bitter pill. Then you can repent. You can, you know, mend your ways. Afterwards, you become a good man. But at this time, you have to do it. Although it is very bad, it is something wicked, it is something haram, it is forbidden, but I have to do it. So take this bitter pill at this time at least. But then later on, you become righteous and you become the all gentle.
قال قائل منهم لا تقتلوا يوسف وألقوه في غيابة الجب يلتقطه بعض السيارة إن كنتم فاعلين.
Said a speaker among them, "Do not kill Joseph, but throw him into the bottom of the well. Some travelers will pick him up if you would do something."
So said one who said from amongst them, don't kill Yusuf. وَالْقُوهُ فِي غَيَابَةِ الْجُبِّ. You just throw him in some well. يَلْتَقِطْهُ بَعْضُ السَّيَّارَةِ. He will be taken out from there by some caravan, travelers. In kuntum fa'ilin, if you are bent upon doing something. You know, among them was also some sinners, you know, advice. He was the eldest, and he said, you know, he was the most gentle among them. First of all, don't kill. And if you are bent upon doing it, because now we are a group, majority of you want to do something, but I can't resist. But if you are bent upon doing something, then only you throw him some well, so that some caravan comes. When they will draw water, Yusuf will come out, and they will take him, you know, to some other land.
قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا مَا لَكَ لَا تَأْمَنَّا عَلَى يُوسُفَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَنَاصِحُونَ.
They said, "O our father, why do you not entrust us with Joseph, while indeed we are to him sincere counselors?"
قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا مَا لَكَ لَا تَأْمَنَّا عَلَى يُوسُفَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَنَاصِحُونَ. They said, "O our father, what's with you? What's the cause that you don't trust us regarding Yusuf, alayhi salatu wasalam? Why na lahu lanasir? We are most sincere well-wishers to him. You think we are enemies to him? No, we are most sincere. We are his well-wishers. But you don't trust us."
أرسله معنا غدا يرتع ويلعب وإنا له لحافظون.
Send him with us tomorrow that he might eat well and play, and indeed we will be his guardians.
أرسله معنا يرتع ويلعب. Send him tomorrow with us so that he should eat and play. We are going out hunting. We should also, you know, when one goes out, can have some wild fruit, you know, from the jungle and so on. So he'll play. أَرْسِلُوا مَعَنَا غَدًا يَتَعْيَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. And we shall be protectors. We promise. We shall protect him.
قَالَ إِنِّي لَيَحْزُنُنِي أَن تَذْهَبُوا بِهِ وَأَخَافُ أَن يَأْكُلَهُ الذِّئْبُ وَأَنْتُمْ عَنْهُ غَافِلُونَ.
Jacob said, "Indeed, it saddens me that you should take him, and I fear that a wolf would eat him while you are of him unaware."
قَالَ إِنِّي لَيَحْزُنُنِي أَن تَذْهَبُوا بِهِ وَأَخَافُ أَن يَأْكُلَهُ الذِّئْبُ وَأَنْتُمْ عَنْهُ غَافِلُونَ. He said, "It very much grieves me. Maybe that you take him with you, and then you become unaware of him, heedless about him, and some wolf comes and eats him and devours him." As if he himself gave the hint, you know, what to do and what to say.
قَالُوا لَئِنْ أَكَلَهُ الذِّئْبُ وَنَحْنُ عُصْبَةٌ إِنَّا إِذَا لَخَاسِرُونَ
They said, if a wolf should eat him while we are a strong clan, indeed we would then be losers.
قَالُوا لَئِنْ أَكَلَهُ الذِّئْبُ وَنَحْنُ عُصْبَةٌ إِنَّا إِذَا لَخَاسِرُونَ They said, oh father, look to it. We are a strong group. 10 of us, 11 now, because Benjamin is also to go with us. Now in our presence, if a wolf can come and eat him and devour him, then we are in a loss. We are nothing. We are meaningless then.
فَلَمَّا ذَهَبُوا بِهِ وَأَجْمَعُوا أَن يَجْعَلُوهُ فِي غَيَابَةِ الْجُبِّ وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْهِ لَتُنَبِّئَنَّهُمْ بِأَمْرِهِمْ هَذَا وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ
So when they took him out and agreed to put him in the bottom of the well, but we inspired to him, you will surely inform them someday about this affair of theirs while they do not perceive your identity.
فَلَمَّا ذَهَبُوا بِهِ When they went with him, took him out. Wajma'u, that is mean ajma'u kaidahum. They gathered, you know, their will and decision. And they agreed upon it. An yaj'aluhu fi ghiyabat al-jub, that they should put him in that depths of that well. Wa'uhayna ilayh. And we put it in his heart. Now wahi here, you know, it is not the wahi of nabuwa. Wa'uhayna ilayh. It is just like the wahi to the, even you know, the honey bee, you know, the also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so yuhi rabbuka ila nahl. In the same way, it's an inspiration, not revelation. We inspired him. لَتُنَبِّئَنَّهُمْ بِأَمْرِهِمْ هَذَا Oh Yusuf, don't fear, a time will come. You will tell them that they did this to you. You will inform them what they are doing. وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ And they are knowing nothing what they are doing. Or they will not be absolutely knowing that you are Yusuf. It's a reference to what will happen in the end. That you will tell them what you did with Yusuf. So actually in this there was a solace for Yusuf. You will not be killed. You will not be wasted. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthened his heart. Take heart. We are with you. A time will come. Then you will inform them what they are doing to you today.
جاءوا أباهم عشاء يبكون.
And they came to their father at night weeping.
وجاءوا أباهم عشاء يبكون. And they came to their father at the nightfall weeping.
قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا إِنَّا ذَهَبْنَا نَسْتَبِقُ وَتَرَكْنَا يُوسُفَ عِنْدَ مَتَاعِنَا فَأَكَلَهُ الذِّئْبُ وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُؤْمِنٍ لَنَا وَلَوْ كُنَّا صَادِقِينَ
They said, O our father, Indeed, we went racing each other and left Joseph with our possessions, and a wolf ate him. But you would not believe us, even if we were truthful.
And they said, Oh, our father, we went away racing with each other. And we left Yusuf with our goods, our clothes, clothing, etc., goods. And a wolf ate him up, devoured him. وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ لَنَا وَلَوْ كُنَّا صَادِقِينَ And you are not going to believe us. Although we might be absolutely truthful, but you will never believe it.
وَجَاءُوا عَلَىٰ قَمِيصِهِ بِدَمٍ كَذِبٍ قَالَ بَلْ سَوَّلَتْ لَكُمْ أَنفُسُكُمْ أَمْرًا فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ وَاللَّهُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَى مَا تَصِفُونَ
And they brought upon his shirt false blood. Jacob said, Rather, your souls have enticed you to something, so patience is most fitting. And Allah is the one sought for help against that which you describe.
وَجَاءُوا عَلَىٰ قَمِيْسِهِ بِدَمٍ كَذِبٍ. And they brought on the shirt of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam false blood. قَالَ بَلْ سَوَّلَتْ لَكُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ أَمْرًا. Hazrat Yaqub said, your minds have enticed you to invent this matter. فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ. So for me, it's the time to have patience and beautiful patience. He could be, you know, hot. He could be furious. He could abuse them. Everything could be done. But sabrun jameel, beautiful. Fasabrun jameel. Wallahu al-musta'anu ala ma tasifun. You know, as the command came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wasbir ala ma yaquluna wahjurhum hajran jameela. So you have patience on whatever they are saying. You have to bear it. And you should, you know, leave them. But this leaving should not be in a very beautiful way, so that you can meet again. فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ وَاللَّهُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَىٰ مَا تَصِفُونَ. And only تَصِفُونَ, and only Allah can be called for help on what you are describing.
وَجَاءَتْ سَيَّارَةٌ فَأَرْسَلُوا وَارِدَهُمْ فَأَدْلَى دَلْوَهُ قَالَ يَا بُشْرَى هَذَا غُلَامٌ وَأَسَرُّوهُ بِضَاعَةٌ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ.
And there came a company of travelers. Then they sent their water drawer, and he let down his bucket. He said, good news, here is a boy. And they concealed him, taking him as merchandise. And Allah was knowing of what they did.
وَجَاءَتْ سَيَّارَةٌ. And as the brother had said, a caravan of travelers came. فَأَرْسَلُوا وَارِدَهُمْ. They sent ahead their water drawer. فَأَدْلَى دَلْوَهُ. And that person, the water drawer, he sent down his bucket. قَالَ يَا بُشْرَى هَذَا غُلَامٌ. And he said, oh, congratulations. Good tidings. There we have found a youth. هَذَا غُلَامٌ وَأَسَرُّهُ بِضَاعَةٍ. And they hid him as a merchandise. So now we can sell him. We can make money from him. So they hid him. وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ. And Allah knew what they were doing. And Allah himself intended that it should be done, because he had to be taken to Egypt. How could he go by himself to Egypt? The caravan was heading towards Egypt.
وَشَرَوْهُ بِثَمَنٍ بَخْسٍ دَرَاهِمَ مَعْدُودَةٍ وَكَانُوا فِيهِ مِنَ الزَّاهِدِينَ.
And they sold him for a reduced price, a few dirhams. And they were, concerning him, of those content with little.
وَشَرَوْهُ بِثَمَنٍ بَخْسٍ دَرَاهِمَ مَعْدُودَةٍ. And they sold him for a paltry price. A few counted dirhams. وَكَانُوا فِيهِ مِنَ الزَّاهِدِينَ. And they were very ascetic regarding the demanding of their price. Because they had not paid anything. It was just free for them. Had they paid some money, they would have included that, you know, cost, and then added to that cost their own profit. But here they found it without any price, so they accepted a very low price also.
وقال الذي اشتراه من مصر لامرأته أكرمي مثواه عسى أن ينفعنا أو نتخذه ولدا. وكذلك مكنا ليوسف في الأرض ولنعلمه من تأويل الأحاديث والله غالب على أمره ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون.
And the one from Egypt who bought him said to his wife, make his residence comfortable. Perhaps he will benefit us, or we will adopt him as a son. And thus we established Joseph in the land, that we might teach him the interpretation of events. And Allah is predominant over his affair, but most of the people do not know.
وَقَالُ الَّذِي اشْتَرَاهُ مِنْ مِصْرِ. Now we come to Misr. Now some of the Egyptologists, they have, you know, fixed the year of the entrance of Yusuf into Egypt as 1890 before Christ. And it seems to be like that because, you know, 2000 years or so, 2000 plus, was the era of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, 2000 plus before Christ. And now because he is the great-grandson of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, and he was 17 at this age when he was thrown in the well and he was taken out and then he was sold. That was the 17th year of his age. And it was the year 1890 before Christ. وَقَالَ الَّذِي اشْتَرَاهُ مِنْ مِصْرِ. Now they brought him to the market of the slaves in Egypt. And said the person who bought him, who purchased him in Misr, in Egypt, لِمْرَاتِهِ, to his wife, أَكْرَمِي مَسْوَاهُ. Make his lodgings goodly. أَسَا يَنْفَعْنَا. Maybe that he gives us some benefit. We can sell him for a higher price. أَوْ نَتَّخِذَهُ وَلَدًا. And it can also be possible that we adopt him as a son. They didn't have any son. وَكَذَلِكَ مَكَّنَّا لِيُوسُفْ. And this is how we establish Yusuf in the land, fil ard. Now you know it was a cradle of civilization. It was an empire. And this person, you know, he was Al-Aziz. So to say the chief executive officer. Maybe in our terminology the prime minister. Or the senior minister in this system of, you know, for example in French system, senior chief minister. So he was having a very big position. And now he was lodged in his house and people were coming over there, high gentry, aristocrats coming, you know, and talking, and he was listening to them. So actually he was trained over there for all the political affairs, all the affairs of community. And all, what are the problems, how they are set, how they are, you know, resolved, how can they be solved. So all these things, because he was lodged in the house of the chief executive of Egypt. وَكَذَلَكَ مَكَّلْنَا لِيُوسُفَ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلِنُعَلِّمَهُ مِنْ تَعْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ. Being there in that high society, at that house, because whenever some visitors would be coming to Al-Aziz of Misr, you know, he would call upon Yusuf, okay, bring this for him and for them, and you know, serve them, and so on. So he was always listening to what was happening. In that way, he gained the capability of interpreting all things, you know. Something is appearing to be something else, and behind is something else. To know what is behind it, that is the Ta'wilul Ahadith. You go to the root, to the background. What is the real cause? What is the underlying cause? So that is actually Ta'wil al-Ahadith. لِنُعَلِّمَهُ مِنْ تَعْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ وَاللَّهُ غَالِبٌ عَلَىٰ أَمْرِهِ. And surely Allah is all powerful over His command and over His decisions. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْسَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But most of the people don't know it. They think what we are doing is best. And it will happen as we are designing it and devising it to happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may use your ill designs against a person in a way that it becomes beneficial for him.
وَلَمَّا بَلَغَ أَشُدَّهُ آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ.
And when Joseph reached maturity, we gave him judgment and knowledge. And thus we reward the doers of good.
And when he reached his maturity, about 18 or 19 years of age, mature, we gave him the judgment and the knowledge, the wisdom and the knowledge. And in this way, we reward the people who do good or who are best in their deen.
وَرَاوَدَتْهُ الَّتِي هُوَ فِي بَيْتِهَا عَن نَفْسِهِ وَغَلَّقَتِ الْأَبْوَابَ وَقَالَتْ هَيْتَ لَكَ قَالَ مَعَاذَ اللَّهِ إِنَّهُ رَبِّي أَحْسَنَ مَثْوَايِ إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الظَّالِمُونَ.
And she, in whose house he was, sought to seduce him. She closed the doors and said, "Come, you." He said, "I seek the refuge of Allah. Indeed, He is my master, who has made good my residence. Indeed, wrongdoers will not succeed."
And a woman in whose house he was, she tried to seduce him sexually. وَغَلَّقَتَ الْأَبْوَابِ, and she closed the doors. وَقَالَتْ هَيْتَ لَكَ, and said, "Come on." قَالَ مَعَاذَ اللَّهِ, he said, "My refuge is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I take refuge in Allah. إِنَّهُ رَبِّي أَحْسَنَ مَثْوَايَ, He is my Lord, and He has, kept me here in the best of the ways. My lodging in best way." Now there is a different opinion. Rabbi means either Allah or the master. Because the master, who has bought him. This was also an idiom of that time that he is the Rabb, he is the Lord. This will be used by Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam to his two companions of the prison. And this word is used for your king or your master, Rabb. So this Rabb, has a very broad meaning. Rabbul Mal, the owner of the capital. Rabbul Bayt, the owner of the house. So actually the Rabb, he was the master, the Aqa, to whom he was a bondsman because he had bought him. Innahu ahsana rabbi masa. I can't do this against him. You are his wife. And he kept me in the best of the ways. Innahu la yuflihu zalimun. Verily, the evildoers can never prosper.
وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ بها لولا أن رأى برهان ربه كذلك لنصرف عنه السوء والفحشاء إنه من عبادنا المخلصين.
And she certainly determined to seduce him, and he would have inclined to her had he not seen the proof of his Lord. And thus it was that we should avert from him evil and immorality. Indeed, he was of our chosen servants.
وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا. And certainly she besought him. And he would also have besought her. لَوْلَا رَّى بُرْهَانَ رَبِّهِ. Had he not seen the burhan of his Lord, of his Rabb. Now what is that burhan? Generally, it is said that there was a miracle that on the wall appeared the figure of Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salam, and he forbade him, "Don't hold yourself." But Abdullah Yusuf Ali has explained it in a very different way, and I think it's a beautiful way. I can't say that it is the only way, but it is a beautiful way. She was blind with passions and emotions, but Yusuf was. Spiritually, he was seeing. So actually this was the Burhan. He saw Allah. Because spiritually he believed in Allah. She only thought that nobody is seeing because I have already closed the doors. And she was blind due to passions. But Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, because he believed in Allah, who always sees, you are always in his sight. So that was the Burhan according to Abdullah Yusuf Ali. And Allah better knows. كَذَلِكَ لِنَصْرِفَ عَنْهُ السُّوءُ. And it was so that we should turn away from him the evil and indecency and all shameful acts. وَالْفَحْشَاء and all shameful acts. إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ. Verily, he was from among chosen bondsmen. This is not مُخْلِصِين. Some people have mistranslated it. Sincere. مُخْلِص is something else. مُخْلَص is something else. Mukhlis is ismul fa'il. And Mukhlas is Ismul Maf'ool. And he was one of those whom we have chosen.
وَاسْتَبَقَ الْبَابَ وَقَدَّتْ قَمِيصَهُ مِنْ دُبُرٍ وَأَلْفَ يَا سَيِّدَهَا لَدَى الْبَابِ قَالَتْ مَا جَزَاءُ مَنْ أَرَادَ بِأَهْلِكَ سُوءًا إِلَّا أَنْ يُسْجَنَ أَوْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ.
And they both raced to the door, and she tore his shirt from the back, and they found her husband at the door. She said, "What is the recompense of one who intended evil for your wife, but that he be imprisoned or a painful punishment?"
Both of them raced towards the door. Hazrat Yusuf tried to run away, and she chased him. And this chase, you know, she caught hold of the shirt, definitely from the backside, min duburin, and it was torn. فَأَلْفَيَا سَيِّدَهَا لَدَى الْبَابِ. And it came to happen that they found the Sayyid, the master, you know, the husband of that woman, he was on the door. Now, look to the intelligence of this woman. قَالَتْ مَا جَزَاءُ مَنْ أَرَادَ بِأَهْلِكَ سُوءًا. She said, "Oh, what should be the recompense of the one who tried to have something bad and ill with your wife, who tried to assault your wife? Illa yusjana, except this, that he should be imprisoned, aw azabun aleem, or some other painful torment."
قَالَ هِيَ رَاوَدَتْنِي عَن نَفْسِي وَشَهِدَ شَاهِدٌ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا إِنْ كَانَ قَمِيصُهُ قُدَّ مِنْ قُبُلٍ فَصَدَقَتْ وَهُوَ مِنَ الْكَاذِبِينَ.
Joseph said, "It was she who sought to seduce me, and a witness from her family testified, if his shirt is torn from the front, then she has told the truth, and he is of the liars."
قَالَ هِيَ رَاوَدَتْنِي عَن نَفْسِي. Yusuf said, "It is she who tried to seduce me sexually." وَشَهِدَ شَاهِدٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِهَا. Now this is very important. Both of them, you know, two just persons, they appear to be very just. Now a person from her family, in أَهْلِهَا, مِّنْ أَهْلِهَا, belonging to her family, he gave a witness, he gave a testimony. إِنْ كَانَ قَمِيصُهُ قُدَّ مِّنْ قُبُلٍ. If his shirt is torn from the front, فَصَدَقَتْ, then she is correct. She is telling the truth. وَهُوَ مِنِ الْكَاذِبِينَ. And he is from among the liars.
وَإِن كَانَ قَمِيصُهُ قُدَّ مِن دُبُرٍ فَكَذَبَتْ وَهُوَ مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ.
But if his shirt is torn from the back, then she has lied, and he is of the truthful.
وَإِنْ كَانَ قَمِيصُهُ قُدَّ مِنْ دُبُرٍ. And if his shirt has been torn from the back, فَكَذَبَتْ, then she is telling a lie. وَهُوَ مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ. Whatever he is saying is true.
فَلَمَّا رَآ قَمِيصَهُ قُدَّ مِنْ دُبُرٍ قَالَ إِنَّهُ مِنْ كَيْدِكُنْ إِنَّ كَيْدَكُنَّ عَظِيمٌ.
So when her husband saw his shirt torn from the back, he said, "Indeed, it is of the woman's plan. Indeed, your plan is great."
وَلَمَّا رَا قَمِيصَهُ قُدَّ مِنْ دُبُرٍ. And when he saw that the shirt of Yusuf alayhi salatu was salam was torn from the back, قَالَ إِنَّهُ مِنْ كَيْدِكُنَّ. Immediately he said, to his wife, it is from your machinations, from your guile. Inna kaida kunna azim. Verily, the machinations and guiles of you women are very great.
Yusuf, a'rid an hadha, wastaghfiri li zanbiki innaki kunti min al-khati'in.
Joseph, ignore this. And, my wife, ask forgiveness for your sin. indeed you were of the sinful.
Yusuf aridan hadha. Now we appeal to Yusuf. You just ignore it. Don't mention this to anybody. Just, you know, keep quiet about it. And just ignore it. Yusuf aridan hadha. Wastaghfiri li dhanbiki. And he said to his wife, and you should beg pardon of your sin, of your ill deed. And innaka kunta min al-khatin, verily, you were the evil doer, and you were the guilty.
قَالَ نِسْوَةٌ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ امْرَأَةُ الْعَزِيزِ تُرَاوِدُ فَتَاهَا عَن نَفْسِهِ قَدْ شَغَفَهَا حُبَّا إِنَّا لَنَرَاهَا فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ.
And women in the city said, the wife of Al-Aziz is seeking to seduce her slave boy. He has impassioned her with love. Indeed, we see her to be in clear error.
فَقَالَ نِسْوَةٌ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ اِمْرَاتُ الْعَزِيزِ تُرَابِدُ فَتَاهَا عَن نَفْسِهِ. Now this, you know, this news broke and reached that higher society. Because, you know, the aristocrats in that society, the begamat, you know, the wives, now they were talking to each other. قَالَتْ نِسْوَةٌ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ اِمْرَاتُ الْعَزِيزِ تُرَابِدُ فَتَاهَا عَن نَفْسِهِ. What has happened to this wife of this chief minister, prime minister, chief executive officer? She wants to seduce her slave. قَدْ شَغَفَهَا حُبَّا. Verily, he has incited in her, aroused in her intense love for him. قَدْ شَغَفَهَا حُبَّا. إِنَّا لَنْرَاهَا فِي ذَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. We see her. She has gone very, very away from and very manifestly in, you know, error.
فَلَمَّا سَمِعَتْ بِمَكْرِهِنَّ أَرْسَلَتْ إِلَيْهِنَّ وَأَعْتَدَتْ لَهُنَّ مُتَّكَأً وَآتَتْ كُلَّ وَاحِدَةٍ مِنْهُنَّ سِكِّينًا وقالت اخرج عليهن. فلما رأينه أكبرنه وقطعن أيديهن وقلن حاش لله ما هذا بشرا إن هذا إلا ملك كريم.
So when she heard of their scheming, she sent for them and prepared for them a banquet, and gave each one of them a knife, and said to Joseph, "Come out before them." And when they saw him, they greatly admired him, and cut their hands, and said, "Perfect is Allah. This is not a man. This is none but a noble angel."
فَلَمَّا سَمِعَتْ بِمَكْرِهِنَّ. And when she, Zalikha, the wife of that chief minister or Aziz of Misr, when she heard about مَكْرِهِنَّ, their malicious talk, أَرْسَلَتْ إِلَيْهِنَّ. She sent for them all to a banquet. وَعَتَدْ لَهُنَّ مُتَّكَانْ. And arranged a banquet for them. وَعَاتَتْ كُلَّ وَاحِدَةٍ مِّنْهُنَّ سِكِّينًا. And gave to every one of them a knife to cut the fruits, etc. وَقَالَتْ اُخْرُجْ عَلَيْهِنَّ. قَالَتْ اُخْرُجْ عَلَيْهِنَّ. And he then commanded to Yusuf, "Now come out before them." Maybe for service or something else. فَلَمَّا رَأَيْنَهُ. When all of them saw him, أَكْبَرْنَهُ. They exalted him very much. وَقَطَّعْنَ أَيْدِيَهُنَّ. And they cut their hands. Now, not by mistake, please note. قَطَّعْنَ. قَطَّعَ يُقَطِّعُ تَقْطِيعًا. It is from tafheel. It can only be willfully doing it. Each one of them wanted to draw the attention of Yusuf alayhi salam to him. It's just possible that one might have cut by mistake. And because Hazrat Yusuf, you know, he turned to her, and, you know, attending her. So every one of them, you know, now cut the fingers or head intentionally. قَطَّعْنَ أَيْدِيَهُنَّ. وَقُلْنَ حَاشَا لِلَّهِ And they cut their hands in amazement and exclaimed, Allah blameless. حَاشَا لِلَّهِ مَا هَذَا بَشَرًا This is not a mortal human being. إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا مَلَكٌ كَرِيمٌ He is none but a noble angel.
قَالَتْ فَذَلِكُنَّ الَّذِي لُمْتُنَّنِي فِيهِ وَلَقَدْ رَاوَدْتُهُ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ فَاسْتَعْصَمْ وَلَئِنْ لَمْ يَفْعَلْ مَا آمُرُهُ لَيُسْجَنَنَّ وَلَيَكُونًا مِّنَ الصَّاغِرِينَ
She said, That is the one about whom you blamed me, and I certainly sought to seduce him, but he firmly refused. And if he will not do what I order him, he will surely be imprisoned and will be of those debased.
Now she said, this is the one about whom you had been blaming me. And surely, indeed, I tried to seduce him. But he held back. He held himself. He abstained. وَإِلَّا لَمْ يَفْعَلْ مَا أَمُرَهُ And if he is not going to do what I am asking him to do, لَيُسْجَنَنَّ He will definitely be put in the prison. وَلَيَكُونَ مِّنَ الصَّاغِرِينَ And he will become the degraded, from the degraded ones. Now hearing all this conversation, Hazrat Yusuf is hearing it. Now he turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In prayer.
قال رب السجن أحب إلي مما يدعونني إليه وإلا تصرف عني كيدهن أصب إليهن وأكن من الجاهلين
He said, My Lord, Prison is more to my liking than that to which they invite me. And if you do not avert me from their plan, I might incline toward them and thus be of the ignorant.
قَالَ رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مَا يَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيْهِ O Allah, my Lord, prison is more preferable to me than the way to which these women are calling me. يَدْعُونَنِي Now here is again plural. Not only that wife of Al-Aziz, but all these women, the society was corrupt. The higher society, that was absolutely corrupt. What is happening to the Royal Society of Britain? Royal Family of Britain. All these stories, you know. All, along with the confessions, clear confessions. On the media, throughout the world. So actually, she was not very much ashamed of what she did. She clearly said, yes, yes, I did it. But he held back. He abstained. He didn't respond. But now, if he doesn't respond in future, I'm bent upon it. And if he doesn't respond positively, he'll be put in prison. Now what she said, رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا يَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيْهِ O my Lord, prison is preferable to me than to what they are calling me. وَإِلَّا تَصْرِفْ عَنِّي كَيْدَهُنَّ And if you don't turn away from me their machinations, أَصْبُهِنَّ إِلَيْهِنَّ It's just possible that I might incline towards them. وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ And then I will become from the ignorance. I'll be the loser. You know, after all, I'm a human being. And you're seeing, you know, to their machinations. They can go to the extent of cutting their hands so that I can have any attention towards them. So maybe if they continue, one after the other, All these means, maybe I might slip. أَصْبُوا إِلَيْهِنَّ Maybe I incline towards them.
فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ فَصَرَفَ عَنْهُ كَيْدَهُنْ إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ
So his Lord responded to him and averted from him their plan. Indeed, he is the hearing, the knowing.
فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ So his Lord accepted his prayer. فَصَرَفَ عَنْهُ كَيْدَهُنَّ And he turned away from him their machinations. إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ Verily, he is all listening, all knowing.
ثُمَّ بَدَى لَهُمْ بعد ما رأوا الآيات ليسجننه حتى حين
Then it appeared to them after they had seen the signs that Al-Aziz should surely imprison him for a time.
ثم بدا لهم من بعد ما رأوا الآيات And then it came to occur to them. It appeared to them to be advisable. Even after seeing all these signs, he had seen for himself, the chief minister, what had happened in his house. He knew it. He had himself said, you are guilty, to his wife. And he had said to Hazrat Yusuf, Arizan Hazrat, now just ignore it. Let it go away. But now they thought, and this is actually the public safety now. For the public safety, he must be put into the prison. Because, you know, we can't hold back our women. So it's better that he should be put in the prison. These are the laws, safety laws in so many countries. The TADA in India. And there's going to be, and it's under, you know, legislative process, undergoing different stages. The Omnibus Anti-Terrorist Act. Anybody, any American, either a citizen or an alien, you know, if he's a citizen, he could be put to prison without proving any charge against him. And if he is an alien, he can be just turned out from the country. Without proving. Now nothing was proved against him. ثُمَّ بَدَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا رَأَوُ الْآيَاتِ لَيَسْجُنَنَّهُ حَتَّىٰ حِينٍ It is better, more advisable to put him in the prison for some time to come.
وَدَخَلَ مَعَهُ السِّجْنَ فَتَيَانِ قَالَ أَحَدُهُمَا إِنِّي أَرَانِي أَعْصِرُ خَمْرًا وَقَالَ الْآخَرُ إِنِّي أَرَانِي أَحْمِلُ فَوْقَ رَأْسِي خُبْزًا تَأْكُلُ الطَّيْرُ مِنْهُ نَبِّئْنَا بِتَأْوِيلِهِ إِنَّا نَرَاكَ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ
And there entered the prison with him two young men. One of them said, Indeed, I have seen myself in a dream pressing wine. The other said, Indeed, I have seen myself carrying upon my head some bread from which the birds were eating. Inform us of its interpretation. Indeed, we see you to be of those who do good.
وَدَخَلَ مَعَهُ السِّجْنَ فَتَيَانِ And with him entered the prison two youths. قَالَ أَحَدُهُمَا One of them said to him, إِنِّي أَرَانِي أَعْصِرُ خَمْرًا I see in my vision myself pressing wine. وَقَالَ الْآخَرُ And the other one said, إِنِّي أَرَانِي أَحْمِلُ فَوْقَ رَاسِي خُبْزًا I see in my vision, in my dream, that I am carrying bread on my head. تَأْخُذُ الطَّيْرُ مِنْهُ And the birds are eating it from it. نَبِّئْنَا بِتَأْوِيلِهِ Tell us the interpretation of this dream. إِنَّا نَرَاكَ مِنَ الْمُحْسَنِينَ We see you to be a very good character man. You are a very good man. You don't seem to be criminal like ourselves, you know. In the prison, all others are criminals, but you are a different type of person. You seem to be a very gentle person, knowledgeable person. So actually, if you can, please tell us the interpretation.
قَالَ لَا يَأْتِيكُمَا طَعَامٌ تُرْزَقَانِهِ إِلَّا نَبَّأْتُكُمَا بِتَأْوِيلِهِ قَبْلَ أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمَا ذلكما مما علمني ربي إني تركت ملة قوم لا يؤمنون بالله وهم بالآخرة هم كافرون
He said, You will not receive food that is provided to you, except that I will inform you of its interpretation before it comes to you. That is from what my Lord has taught me. Indeed, I have left the religion of a people who do not believe in Allah, and they, in the hereafter, are disbelievers.
قال لا ياتيكما طعام ترزقانه الا نبأتكما بتاويله قبل ان ياتيكما. He said, the food which comes to you, which is given to you every day, the ration in the prison, now today, when that food is given to you, before that time, I will tell you the interpretation of your dreams. What does it mean? He wanted to borrow some time, to buy some time. Because now they had turned to him, he wanted to preach to them the truth of the deen. Because after all, he was son of a prophet, Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salam. He was fully grown, he was 17 when he was taken away from his home. So he knew his grandfather Ibrahim, great-grandfather Ibrahim, and his grandfather Ishaq, and his father Yaqub, and what is the creed, what they believe in it, and what is the belief that he had. So he wanted to preach it. ذَلِكُمَا مِمَّا عَلَّمَنِي رَبِّي. And this is from what my Lord has taught me. He is not taking the credit for himself. This is another thing, you know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught me these things. He kept me there in the house of the chief minister. I was there in that society, topmost society. I had the occasions to learn things, to interpret the things. But all things were arranged for me by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody could have done it to me without his command. ذَلِكُمَا مِمَّا عَلَّمَنِي رَبِّي إِنِّي تَرَكْتُ مِلَّةَ قَوْمٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَلَا وَهُمْ بِالْآخِرَتِهُمْ كَافِرُونَ. I have left the creed of those people who don't believe in Allah, and also they reject Akhirah. They don't believe in resurrection. They don't believe in the hereafter.
وَاتَّبَعْتُ مِلَّةَ آبَائِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ مَا كَانَ لَنَا أَن نُشْرِكَ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ ذَلِكَ مِنْ فضل الله علينا وعلى الناس ولكن أكثر الناس لا يشكرون.
And I have followed the religion of my fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and it was not for us to associate anything with Allah. That is from the favor of Allah upon us and upon the people, but most of the people are not grateful.
وَاتَّبَعْتُ مِلَّةَ آبَائِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ. And I have now consciously, although he was a son or a grandson or a great-grandson of the prophets, but now, when he comes of an age, now this is actually a conscious rejuvenation or revitalization of faith. Conscious. So he says, وَاتَّبَعْتُ مِلَّةَ آبَائِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ. And I have decided to follow the creed of my forefathers, my fathers Ibrahim and Ishaq and Yaqub. مَا كَانَ لَنَا نُشْرِكَ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. It's not worthy of us. It's not befitting for us that we should associate anything with Allah. ذَلِكَ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْنَا. This is the grace or bounty of Allah to us. He made us superior to every other creature. On us means especially on Ibrahim, Ishaq, Yaqub and me, but on the all of humanity. Because you know they were created as vastirans of Allah on earth, and all the angels were made to prostrate before Adam alayhi salatu was salam. And we should now associate certain things, you know, to with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and try to and start worshipping them. It's not befitting for us. ذَلِكَ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْنَا وَعَلَى النَّاسِ and on all the people, all the mankind. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَشْكُرُونَ. But most of the people are not thankful.
يَا صَاحِبَيِ السِّجْنِ أَأَرْبَابٌ مُتَفَرِّقُونَ خَيْرٌ أَمِ اللَّهُ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَّارُ.
O my two companions of prison, are separate lords better or Allah, the One, the Prevailing.
Ya Sahib Yassin, O two of my companions in the prison, Arbabun Mutafarriquna Khairun Amillahul Wahidul Qahar. You think for yourself. Are so many scattered gods better? Or the One, Allah, the One, who is all powerful, who controls everything, who has power over everything? If you have to serve so many masters, is it easy? To serve one master, it's very easy. You know what are his priorities, what are his preferences. But you know, if you have to serve two, maybe their preferences and priorities clash with each other. So to whom to serve and whom to deny? You'll be in a fix. So, أَرْبَابٌ مُتَفَرِّقُونَ خَيْرٌ أَمِ اللَّهُ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَارِ.
ما تعبدون من دونه إلا أسماء سميتموها أنتم وآباؤكم ما أنزل الله بها من سلطان إن الحكم إلا لله أمر ألا تعبدوا إلا إياه ذلك الدين القيم ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون.
You worship not besides him, except mere names you have named them, you and your fathers, for which Allah has sent down no authority. Legislation is not but for Allah. He has commanded that you worship not except him. That is the correct religion, but most of the people do not know.
All these gods whom you are worshipping, leaving alone Allah, leaving away Allah, besides Allah, they are not except only names which you have named and concocted and invented, you and your forefathers. مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ بِهَا مِن سُلْطَانٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not sent down regarding any of those, any authority. إِنِ الْحُكْمُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. Sovereignty, the command, the absolute right of obedience is to Allah and Allah alone. إِلِ الْحُكْمُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ أَمَرَ لَا تَعْبُدُ إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ. And He has commanded that you will not obey, you will not worship anybody except Me. ذَلِكَ الدِّينُ الْقَيِّمُ. This is the straight deen. This is the right system of life. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But most of the people know not.
يا صاحبي السجن أما أحدكما فيسقي ربه خمرا وأما الآخر فيصلب فتأكل الطير من رأسه قضي الأمر الذي فيه تستفتيان.
O two companions of prison, as for one of you, he will give drink to his master of wine. But as for the other, he will be crucified, and the birds will eat from his head. The matter has been decreed about which you both inquire.
Ya Sahib Yassin, O two of my prisoners, co-prisoners, Amma ahadukuma fayasti rabbahu khamra. As for one of you who saw that he was pressing wine in his vision, the interpretation which Yusuf told him, that you will be freed and you will again be restored to your position and you will be pouring out the wine to your Lord, to your King. Now here, Rabb for King. وَأَمَّا الْآخَرَ. And the other one who said that I saw, you know, myself carrying some bread on my head and the birds were eating from it. وَأَمَّا الْآخَرَ. To him he said, he will be fayuslabu, he will be crucified, fatakulu tayru min rasihi, and the birds will be eating from his head. قُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ الَّذِي فِيهِ تَسْتَفْتِيَانِ. This is the decision of the matter about which you wanted to have inquiry and you wanted to have the opinion.
وَقَالَ لِلَّذِي ظَنَّ أَنَّهُ نَاجٍ مِّنْهُمَ اذْكُرْنِي عِندَ رَبِّكَ فَأَنْسَاهُ الشَّيْطَانُ ذِكْرَ رَبِّهِ فَلَبِثَ فِي السِّجْنِ بِضْعَ سِنِينَ.
And he said to the one whom he knew would go free, "Mention me before your master." But Satan made him forget the mention to his master. And Joseph remained in prison several years.
وَقَالَ لِلَّذِي ظَنَّ أَنَّهُ نَاجٍ مِّنْهُمَا. And he asked the one about whom he had thought that he will be freed and he will be saved. اُذْكُرْنِي عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ. You just remember me and mention me in the presence of your Lord, the King. Tell him that a person is there in the prison, innocent, he has done nothing. He is there a prisoner. فَانْسَاهُ الشَّيْطَانُ ذِكْرَ رَبِّهِ. But Satan made him forget, and he didn't remember that Yusuf had said to him that he should mention him to his king. فَلَبِسَ فِي السِّجْنِ بِضْعَ سِنِينَ. So he remained in the prison for a number of years. Now these number of years are said to be 10. When he came out from the prison, he was 30. He was 17, they say, when he was thrown in the well. And then he was taken to Egypt. He remained 3 years at the house of Al-Aziz, the chief executive officer in that government. Then he was imprisoned and remained in prison for 10 years. So when he came out, he was 30.
وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ إِنِّي أَرَى سَبْعَ بَقَرَاتٍ سِمَانٍ يَأْكُلُهُنَّ سَبْعٌ عِجَافٌ وَسَبْعَ سُنْبُلَاتٍ خُضْرٍ وَأُخَرَ يَابِسَاتٍ يَا أَيُّهَا الْمَلَأُ أَفْتُونِي فِي رُؤْيَايَ إِن كُنتُمْ لِلرُّؤْيَا تَعْبُرُونَ.
And subsequently the king said, "Indeed, I have seen in a dream 7 fat cows being eaten by 7 that were lean, and 7 green spikes of grain and others that were dry. O eminent ones, explain to me my vision, if you should interpret visions."
وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ إِنِّي أَرَى سَبْعَ بَقَرَاتٍ. Now this is after about 10 years what is going to happen. Now between these two ayat, you know, there is a gap of 10 years regarding the dates of the incidents. قَالَ الْمَلِكُ, the king said. Now who was this king? First thing that is to be noted is that he is not Fir'aun. Faraina was the title of the kings who belonged to the soil of Egypt, the local nation. You know, the people, they were having their own system and they were having their own kings, and they were called Fir'aun. But actually this king was of the Amalekites, Amalekah. They were from the Arabian desert. They had invaded Egypt and they were governing Egypt at that time. And he was a Semitic in his origin. The Egyptians are said to be the progeny of Hazrat Ham, the second son or the third son of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, not Sam. But you know, people of the Arabian desert and of Iraq and Sham, they were the progeny of Hazrat Sam, Semitics. So they were Semitics, they had invaded Egypt and they were ruling there. So as if they were the alien rulers. And that is why they are not called, you know, they are not called Fir'aun. And they say that his name was, they are called Hyksos kings, and the name of this king was Apophis. And his, you know, his capital was Memphis. وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ إِنِّي أَرَى سَبْعَ بَقَرَاتٍ سِمَانٍ. And the king said to his chieftains in his court, "I am seeing إِنِّي أَرَى." And this means, you know, he saw this vision repeatedly. سَبْعَ بَقَرَاتٍ سِمَانٍ. I see 7 cows, fat ones. يَأْكُلُهُنَّ سَبْعٌ عِجَافٌ. And they are swallowed and devoured by seven who are very lean. وَسَبْعَ سُنْبُلَاتٍ خُضْرٍ And I see in my vision seven ears of corn which are green. وَأُخَرَ يَابِسَاتٍ And another seven which are dry. يَا أَيُّهَا الْمَلَأُ أُطُونِي فِي رُيَايَا أَفْتُونِي فِي رُيَايَا Oh my chiefs, now tell me about my vision. إِن كُنْتُمْ لِرُيَايَا تَعْتَابُرُونَ If you are the interpreters, if you know the expounding of the visions.
قَالُوا أَضْغَاثُ أَحْلَامٍ وَمَا نَحْنُ بِتَأْوِيلِ الْأَحْلَامِ بِعَالِمِينَ
They said, it is but a mixture of false dreams, and we are not learned in the interpretation of dreams.
They said they seem to be mixed up false dreams, and we don't know the interpretation and expounding of this type of dreams which are mixed up, have no reality behind them.
قال الذي نجا منهما وادكر بعد أمة أنا أنبئكم بتأويله فأرسلون
But the one who was freed and remembered after a time said, I will inform you of its interpretation, so send me forth.
وَقَالَ الَّذِي نَجَى مِنْهُمَا Now that person, the two prisoners, and the one who was freed and he was now serving the king, you know, he was to pour the wine in the cup of the king. وَقَالَ الَّذِي نَجَى مِنْهُمَا وَدَّكَرَ بَعْدَ أُمَّتِينَ And now he recalled, after this long period of time, though Yusuf was there and I asked the interpretation of my dream and he could tell it, and then he had told me that I should mention about him in the presence of the king. وَدَّكَرَ بَعْدَ أُمَّتِينَ أَنَا أُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِتَعْوِيلِهِ فَأَرْسِلُونَ I will be able to tell the meanings and the interpretations or the expounding of this vision. So you send me forth to Yusuf in the prison.
يوسف أيها الصديق أفتنا في سبع بقرات سمان يأكلهن سبع عجاف وسبع سنبلات وسبع سنبلات خضر وأخر يابسات لعلي أرجع إلى الناس لعلهم يعلمون
He said, Joseph, O man of truth, explain to us about seven fat cows eaten by seven that were lean, and seven green spikes of grain and others that were dry, that I might return to the people. Perhaps they will know about you.
Now when he has reached the prison, he says, Yusuf, O you have Siddiq, O Yusuf, the true one, as you have Siddiq, aftina fi sab'i baqaratin. Now give us your verdict. In the vision of seven cows, simanin, who are fat, yaakuluhunna, they are being devoured or eaten up, swallowed, sab'un yajafun, by seven cows who are lean. Wa sab'i sumbilatin, and about seven ears of corn, khudrin, which are green. Wa ukhara yabisatin, another seven which are dry. La'alli arji'u ilan nas, so that I may return to the people. La'allahum ya'lamu, so that they can know what is the meaning and interpretation of this dream of the king.
قَالَ تَزْرَعُونَ سَبْعَ سِنِينَ دَأَبًا فَمَا حَصَدتُّمْ فَذَرُوهُ فِي سُنْبُلِهِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِّمَّا تَأْكُلُونَ
Joseph said, You will plant for 7 years consecutively, and what you harvest leave in its spikes, except a little from which you will eat.
قَالَ تَزْرَعُونَ سَبْعَ سِنِينَ دَأَبًا He said, Hazrat Yusuf ﷺ said, You will have normal harvest, usual harvest for 7 years. فَمَا حَسَّدْتُمْ فَذَرُوهُ فِي سُمْبُلِهِ So whatever you reap, you keep it in the ears. Don't take them out. Don't take the corns out. This was the way to preserve it, you know. Illa qalilam mimma ta'kulun, except the little that you eat. Whatever you require, the daily rations, you take out from the ears, but the rest of it, let it be as it is.
يأتي من بعد ذلك سبع شداد يأكلن ما قدمتم لهن إلا قليلا مما تحصنون.
Then will come after that seven difficult years which will consume what you saved for them, except a little from which you will store.
ثم يأتي من بعد ذلك سبع شداد. Then after that, 7 years will be of very hardship. يَاكُلْنَ مَا قَدَّمْتُمْ لَهُنَّ. Those 7 years will eat up what you had stored for them. You will be storing for 7 years. The excess crop will be stored. Keep on storing them. And now when you know there will be drought for 7 years, you will eat up the stored grains. Now, illa qalilam mimma tusadun, except a little amount of it which you will have to preserve for the next crop, as to use it as seeds for the next crop.
Thumma yati min ba'di thalika aamun fihi yughathun nasu wa fihi ya'sirun.
Then will come after that a year in which the people will be given rain and in which they will press olives and grapes.
Then again, after those 7 years, the year will come, فِيهَ يُغَاسُ النَّاسِ, in which the people will have rains, وَفِيهَ يَعْسِرُونَ, and in that year, they will be pressing wine, you know, there will be crop and there will be greenery and everything will be okay and you will be pressing wine.
قَالَ الْمَلِكُ أتوني به فلما جاءه الرسول قال ارجع إلى ربك فاسأله ما بال النسوة اللاتي قطعن أيديهن إن ربي بكيدهن عليم.
And the king said, bring him to me. But when the messenger came to him, Joseph said, return to your master and ask him what is the case of the women who cut their hands. Indeed, my lord is knowing of their plan.
But now he came to the court, he told the interpretation of the vision to the king. Now he said, bring that person to me. He seems to be very wise. فَلَمَّا جَاءَهُ الرَّسُولُ. But when, you know, the messenger from the king came to Yusuf, قَالَ إِرْجِعْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ. He said, go back to your king, to your master, to your lord. فَاسْأَلْهُ. And ask him, مَا بَالُ النِّسْوَةِ اللَّاتِ قَطَّعْنَ أَيْدِيَهُنَّ. What about the women who cut their hands? I was blamed for that. I was imprisoned for that. Without the charge being proved against me. But at least that was said, you know, to be the case. So unless I am, you know, absolved, and you know, I am honorably acquitted of that charge, I am not ready to get out of this prison. Inna Rabbi bikaydihinna alim. Verily, my Lord knows about their machinations, whatever they did. I didn't do anything wrong.
قَالَ مَا خَطْبُكُنَّ إِذْ رَاوَدْتُنَّ يُوسُفَ عَن نَفْسِهِ. قلنا حاش لله ما علمنا عليه من سوء. قالت امرأة العزيز الآن حصحص الحق أنا راودته عن نفسه وإنه لمن الصادقين.
Said the king to the women, what was your condition when you sought to seduce Joseph? They said, perfect is Allah, we know about him no evil. The wife of Al-Aziz said, now the truth has become evident. It was I who sought to seduce him, and indeed he is of the truthful.
قَالَ مَا خَطْبُكُنَّ. Now the king gathered all of them. And he asked them, مَا خَطْبُكُنَّ إِذْ رَاوَدْتُنَّ يُوسُفَ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ. What was the matter with you when you solicited and you wanted to and tried to seduce Yusuf? قُلْنَا حَاشَا لِلَّهِ. They said, by Allah, the blameless. مَا عَلِمْنَا عَلَيْهِ مِنْ سُوءٍ. We don't know, we have no knowledge of anything evil about him. قَالَتْ اِمْرَاتُ الْعَزِيزِ. And now, the wife of that chief minister or the chief executive officer, he spoke out. الآن حصحص الحق. Now that the truth has come out. أنا راودته عن نفسي. I confess that I was trying to seduce him. وإنه لمن الصادقين. And he is absolutely, he is true. He was not a sinner.
ذلك ليعلم أني لم أخنه بالغيب وأن الله لا يهدي كيد الخائنين.
That is so Al-Aziz will know that I did not betray him in his absence, and that Allah does not guide the plan of betrayers.
ذلك ليعلم أني لم أخنه بالغيب. Now about these two ayat, following two ayat, there's very difference of opinion as to who said these words. You know, the continuity of this text, that demands that these are also the sayings of the same woman. But people usually think that these words appear to be coming from a very knowledgeable and a person who believes in Allah and everything, you know. And that woman was not of that character or that level or that stature. And these words, you know, they are befitting only for Yusuf, alayhi salatu wasalam. So one way of interpretation is that Hazrat Yusuf said that I didn't want to expose these women. But I did want that, you know, I should be honorably acquitted. ذَلِكَ لِيَعْلَمَ أَنِّي لَمْ أَخُنُ بِالْغَيْبِ. So that he knows, he should come to know who. The Al-Aziz, the husband of that woman, should come to know that I didn't betrayed him and betrayed his trust in his absence. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي كَيْدَ الْخَائِنِينَ. And I very well know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to make the guile of the betrayers successful.
وَمَا أُبَرِّئُ نَفْسِي إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبِّي إِنَّ رَبِّي غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ.
And I do not acquit myself. Indeed, the soul is a persistent enjoiner of evil, except those upon which my Lord has mercy. Indeed, my Lord is forgiving and merciful.
وَمَا أُبَرِّئُ نَفْسِي. At the same time, I don't declare my soul to be sinless and that it is all free from anything low. إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ سُوءٌ. Verily, the animal self in man commands him to something evil. إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِسُوءٍ. From here, you know, we derive the word نَفْسَ أَمَّارَةٌ. And that is not the self, the higher self. We have two selves within us, the spiritual self and the animal self, the animal soul and the divine spirit. These are two different things. We have a composite existence. So now the baser self, as we call it, or in Freudian terminology, the id or libido, well, all these lusts and desires, sensual gratification, they emerge from that baser self. So I don't absolve myself, because the baser self in every human being urges him for something evil. إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبِّي. Except the one whom the Lord has, you know, shown mercy. إِنَّ رَبِّي غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Verily, my Lord is forgiving and merciful. Now these words, you know, they are befitting to Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. But some of the exegetes, because, you know, the continuity of the text that demands that these words are of wife of Al-Aziz. Maybe that during these 10 years, she might have been transformed. And she might have, you know, reformed herself. And this seems to be, most of the people believe in it, that although she had all the evil designs before that, but now 10 years had passed. And during this period might be that she had, you know, she had made Tawbah, repented, reformed her, and she had become such a, to attain such level of knowledge. Maybe, we can't say.
قال الملك ائتوني به أستخلصه لنفسي فلما كلمه قال إنك اليوم لدينا مكين أمين.
And the king said, bring him to me, I will appoint him exclusively for myself. And when he spoke to him, he said, indeed, you are today established in position and trusted.
وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ اُوْتُونِي. Now this is what I was referring by the context. Now the proceedings of the court are going on. And Hazrat Yusuf has not as yet come to the court according to the sequence of this ayat. وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ اُوْتُونِي بِهِ. Now when all this thing was cleared in the absence of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam in the court of the king, he said, oh, bring him to me. أَسْتَخْلِصُهُ لِنَفْسِي. I will reserve him for myself. Such a noble man, you know, such a person, such a man of such a high character. I will keep him with me exclusively. فَلَمَّا كَلَّمَهُ. And when he came and they had a dialogue, قَالَ إِنَّكَ الْيَوْمَ لَدَيْنَا مَكِينٌ أَمِينٌ. The king said, oh, Yusuf, from this day you will be high in rank near us and a fully trusted person. You will hold a very high position in my court.
قال اجعلني على خزائن الأرض إني حفيظ عليم.
Joseph said, appoint me over the storehouses of the land. Indeed, I will be a knowing guardian.
قال اجعلني على خزائن الأرض. Because Hazrat Yusuf now had the knowledge what is going to happen, what catastrophe is going to come to this land. So he said, قَالَ جَعَلْنِي عَلَىٰ خَضَائِنِ الْأَرْضِ. Now put me in charge of all these storehouses of the land. إِنِّي حَفِيظٌ عَلِيمٌ. I am the best keeper and I am a knowledgeable person. I know how to manage things and I will do it, inshallah. So he knew it, and from here, you know, some of the ulama, they deduce that if a person knows that he can deliver the goods, he can present himself, offer himself for some office. Generally it is believed that nobody should offer himself for an office, because to aspire for office is not good. It is really not good. If you are aspiring for any office or any position for your own sake, but if your intentions are that you know the problem which is going to be faced, you have the know-how and the expertise, and you can, you know, deliver the goods, then you shouldn't keep back, you know, and you should offer yourself. So this is the place from where those ulama, they take the argument and they infer. Because he said, اجعلني على خزائن الأرض. Now place me in charge and authority over all the storehouses of the land. إني حفيظ عليم.
وكذلك مكنا ليوسف في الأرض يتبوأ منها حيث يشاء نصيب برحمتنا من نشاء ولا نضيع أجر المحسنين.
And thus we established Joseph in the land to settle therein wherever he willed. We touch with our mercy whom we will, and we do not allow to be lost the reward of those who do good.
وَكَذَلِكَ مَكَّنَّا لِيُوسُفَ. In this way, we establish Yusuf in the land. يَتَبَوَّهُ مِنْهَا حَيْثُ يَشَاءُ. Enjoying authority as when and where he liked. نُصِيبُ بِرَحْمَتِنَا مَنْ نَشَاءُ. We bestow our mercy on whomsoever we like. وَلَا نُزِي وَجْرَ الْمُحْسَنِينَ. And we are never going to let the reward or recompense of the good doers go in waste.
وَلَأَجْرُ الْآخِرَةِ خَيْرٌ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ.
And the reward of the hereafter is better for those who believed and were fearing Allah.
وَلَأَجْرُ الْآخِرَةِ خَيْرٌ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. And surely the recompense or reward of the akhirah, of the hereafter, is much better for those who believe and who have been fearing Allah, who have been having regard, proper regard for Him. Now another 8 to 10 years have passed between these two ayat, 57 and 58. Now again a pause of about 10 years or 9 years or 8 years at least. Then you know, 7 years went okay, normal harvest, whatever was being reaped, most of it was taken into the storehouses, stored, except the rationing given to the people, the lesser the better. Now the famine starts, and it is the 8th year now when the famine starts, and it is proved in history. It was a very widespread famine. It affected not only the Egypt, but the adjoining areas of Palestine and Syria. And now Hazrat Yaqub, along with his 11 sons, he was residing in Palestine. And here Yusuf was in Egypt. But the drought was so severe and the famine was so widespread that this affliction came to them also. But they came to learn that, well, in Egypt there is a king, and he, has a minister or someone who manages the things, and he is kind enough, and he can give grain and foodstuffs to other people also. So they used to come and get from there some grain.
وجاء إخوة يوسف فدخلوا عليه فعرفهم وهم له منكرون.
And the brothers of Joseph came seeking food, and they entered upon him, and he recognized them, but he was to them unknown.
وجاء إخوة يوسف. Now the brothers of Yusuf came. فدخلوا عليه. They presented him before Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. Who are you? This is our land, and this grain we have stored for ourselves. How come you don't deserve it? So because it was an unusual thing, so they had to be presented that there some people have come from far away and they want that some grain should be issued to them. فَعَرَفَهُمْ. He recognized them. Oh, they are my brothers. فَهُمْ لَهُ مُنْكِرُونَ. But they couldn't recognize him.
وَلَمَّا جَهَّزَهُمْ بِجَهَازِهِمْ قَالَ أَتُونِي بِأَخٍ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَبِيكُمْ أَلَا تَرَوْنَ أَنِّي أُوفِي الْكَيْلَ وَأَنَا خَيْرُ الْمُنْزِلِينَ.
And when he had furnished them with their supplies, he said, "Bring me a brother of yours from your father. Do not you see that I give full measure and that I am the best of accommodators?"
وَلَمَّا جَهَّدَهُمْ بِجَهَادِهِمْ. And when he had provided them with the provisions, قَالَ أَتُونِي بِأَخِلْ لَكُمْ. Now they were 10. Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salam had not let Binyamin go with them. It seems that for every family some measure fixed. This much amount, this much weight will be allowed as a ration for 1 year for each family. So now 10 of them, they came and they said, another family, another brother who is there behind, he has not come with us. He said, okay, but this time when you come, you bring that brother also. وَلَمَّا جَهَّزَهُمْ بِجَهَازِهِمْ قَالُوا أَتُونِي بِأَخِلْ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَبِيكُمْ. Bring to me the brother you have from your father, not your mother's, but your father. أَلَا تَرَوْنَ أَنِي أُوفِي الْكَيْلَ. Don't you see that I fill the mayor? وَأَنَا خَيْرُ الْمُنْزَرِينَ. I am the best of the hosts.
فَإِنْ لَمْ تَأْتُونِي بِهِ فَلَا كَيْلَ لَكُمْ عِنْدِي وَلَا تَقْرَبُونَ.
But if you do not bring him to me, no measure will there be hereafter for you from me, nor will you approach me.
فَإِلَمْ تَعْتُونِي بِهِ. If you don't bring him to me, فَلَا كَيْلَ لَكُمْ عِنْدِي. Then you won't find any measure of these grains with me. وَلَا تَقْرَبُونَ. And don't approach me. Don't come to me at all.
قَالُوا سَنُرَاوِدُ عَنْهُ أَبَاهُ وَإِنَّا لَفَاعِلُونَ.
They said, "We will attempt to dissuade his father from keeping him, and indeed, we will do it."
قَالُوا سَنُرَاوِدُ عَنْهُ أَبَاهُ وَإِنَّا لَفَاعِلُونَ. They said, we shall try to anti-summer father. Now he has become very careful about Benjamin, because what had happened to Yusuf, you know, so he was over careful now. But we'll try to entice him, and we'll do it. Inshallah, we shall be able to do it.
وَقَالَ لِفِتْيَانِهِ اجْعَلُوا بِضَاعَتَهُمْ فِي رِحَالِهِمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَعْرِفُونَهَا إِذَا انْقَلَبُوا إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ.
And Joseph said to his servants, put their merchandise into their saddlebags, so they might recognize it when they have gone back to their people, that perhaps they will again return.
وَقَالَ لِفِتْيَانِهِ جَعْلُوا بِضَاعَتَهُمْ فِي رِحَالِهِمْ. And he, that is Yusuf, said to his boys, you know, Fityanehi, who were working, mayoring and giving, you know, rations, distributing, he said, put their merchandise in their own saddlebags. Now, what price they could offer? People of the desert, coming from the desert, might be some skins of animals, some wool, something of this sort, they had brought it to pay as a price. So he said, okay, whatever they had brought, put them back, put these things in their saddlebags. So that, فِي رِحَالِهِمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَعْرِفُونَهَا إِذَا انْقَلَبُوا إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِمْ. So that when they go back to their families, they remember it and they recognize it. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. So that they will come again. That he was so gracious to us. He gave us the ration and the grains, and then, you know, he returned to us our merchandise.
فَلَمَّا رَجَعُوا إِلَىٰ أَبِيهِمْ قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا مُنِعَ مِنَّا الْكَيْلُ فَأَرْسِلْ مَعَنَا أَخَانَا نَكْتَلْ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ.
So when they returned to their father, they said, O our father, further measure has been denied to us, so send with us our brother, that we will be given measure, and indeed, we will be his guardians.
فَلَمَّا رَجَعُوا إِلَىٰ أَبِيهِمْ قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا. When they returned back to their father, Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا. They said, O our father, مُنِعَ مِنَّ الْكَيْلِ. One measure has been denied to us, because he said, if you have another brother, bring him here, then only I will give, you know, his part, his portion of the ration. فَأَرْسِلْ مَعَنَا أَخَانَا. So please send with us our brother, Benjamin. نَقْتَلْ. We shall have another mayor. وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. And we shall protect him fully.
قَالَ هَلْ آمَنُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ إِلَّا كَمَا أَمِنْتُكُمْ عَلَىٰ أَخِيهِ مِنْ قَبْلِ فَاللَّهُ خَيْرٌ حَافِظًا وَهُوَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ.
He said, should I entrust you with him except under coercion, as I entrusted you with his brother before? But Allah is the best guardian, and he is the most merciful of the merciful.
قَالَ هَلْ آمَنُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ إِلَّا كَمَا أَمِنْتُكُمْ عَلَىٰ أَخِيهِ. He said, should I entrust you to him, entrust him to you, just as I entrusted his brother to you before? فَاللَّهُ خَيْرٌ حَافِظًا. Allah is the best protector. وَهُوَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. The most merciful of all the merciful.
وَلَمَّا فَتَحُوا مَتَاعَهُمْ وَجَدُوا بِضَاعَتَهُمْ رُدَّتْ إِلَيْهِمْ قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا مَا نَبْغِي هَذِهِ بِضَاعَتُنَا رُدَّتْ إِلَيْنَا ونمير أهلنا ونحفظ أخانا ونزداد كيل بعير ذلك كيل يسير.
And when they opened their baggage, they found their merchandise returned to them. They said, O our father, what more could we desire? this is our merchandise returned to us. And we will obtain supplies for our family, and protect our brother, and obtain an increase of a camel's load. That is an easy measurement.
And now when they opened their, you know, goods, and they found their merchandise returned to them. Now again they said, oh our father, what can we desire more? هَذِهِ بِذَاعَتُنَا رُدَّتْ إِلَيْنَا. Our own merchandise has been returned to us. وَنَمِيرُ أَهْلَنَا وَنَحْفَظُ أَخَانَا. And we shall get provision for our family and guard our brother. وَنَسْدَادُ كَيْلَ بَعِيرِ. And shall get an extra measure of a camel's load. ذَلِكَ كَيْلٌ يَسِيرٌ. And this is a very easy thing to get, this may another measure. So send, please send our brother with us.
قال لن أرسله معكم حتى تؤتون موثقا من الله لتأتنني به إلا أن يحاط بكم فلما آتوه موثقهم قال الله على ما نقول وكيل.
Jacob said, never will I send him with you until you give me a promise by Allah that you will bring him back to me, unless you should be surrounded by enemies. And when they had given their promise, he said, Allah, over what we say, is witness.
He said, no, I'm not at all going to send him with you. حَتَّى تُوْتُونِ مَوْثِقًا مِنَ اللَّهِ. Until you have a solemn pledge by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَتَعْتُنَّنِي بِهِ, that you will definitely bring him back to me, إِلَّا يُحَاطَ بِكُمْ, except that you are all rendered helpless, you are all encircled, then it is something else. But never come to me without him, and you have to give me this solemn pledge. فَلَمَّا آتَوْهُ مَوْثِقَهُمْ, when they gave him his solemn pledge, قَالَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ مَا نَقُولُ وَكِيلٌ, then they said, then he said, okay, now Allah is the witness and guardian over what we are saying. This is an agreement.
وَقَالَ يَا بَنِيَّ لَا تَدْخُلُوا مِن بَابٍ وَاحِدٍ وَادْخُلُوا مِن أَبْوَابٍ مُتَفَرِّقَةٍ. وَمَا أُغْنِي عَنْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِنِ الْحُكْمُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ وَعَلَيْهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُتَوَكِّلُونَ.
And he said, O my sons, do not enter from one gate, but enter from different gates. And I cannot avail you against the decree of Allah at all. The decision is only for Allah. Upon Him I have relied, and upon Him let those who would rely indeed rely.
وَقَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ يَا بَنِيَّ, and he said, O my sons, لَا تَدْخُلُوا مِن بَابٍ وَاحِدٍ, don't enter that city from one gate, because people will say 11 are coming. So actually, maybe they feel some jealousy in their minds, 11 brothers together. So, وَدْخُلُوا مِنْ أَبْوَابٍ مُتَفَرَّقَةٍ. So you enter the town different from different gates, two from this, three from this, so that you don't appear to be a big, you know, group. وَمَا أَغْنِي عَنْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ, I cannot save you from Allah anything. إِنِ الْحُكْمُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ, all authority is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ, on Him I have placed all my trust and faith. وَعَلَيْهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُتَوَكِّلُونَ, and surely on Him should all the believers and all those who want to put any trust, in Him should they put their trust.
لَمَّا دَخَلُوا مِنْ حَيْثُ أَمَرَهُمْ أَبُوهُمْ مَا كَانَ يُغْنِي عَنْهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا حَاجَةً فِي نَفْسِ يَعْقُوبَ قَضَاهَا وَإِنَّهُ لَذُو عِلْمٍ لِمَا عَلَّمْنَاهُ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ.
And when they entered from where their father had ordered them, it did not avail them against Allah at all, except it was a need within the soul of Jacob, which he satisfied. And indeed, he was a possessor of knowledge because of what we had taught him, but most of the people do not know.
And when they entered from where their father had asked them to enter, مَا كَانَ يُغْنِي عَنْهُ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. Yaqub couldn't save them from Allah anything. إِلَّا حَاجَةً فِي نَفْسِ يَعْقُوبَ قَضَاهَا. Except that it was only a craving in Yaqub's heart, and he satisfied it. وَإِنَّهُ لَذُو عِلْمٍ لِمَا عَلَّمْنَاهُ. And he knew all the knowledge which we had given to him. The knowledge which we gave, he had it. The knowledge which we didn't give, didn't have it. So it appears that the knowledge which was given was that Yusuf is alive, and he will return to you. But the knowledge which was not given, where he is, he didn't know. And that was, you know, very going to be very hard for him for so many long years. And if you feel, and if you know that your son has died, you have buried him, you know, after some days, you know, you have the patience and you just forget. But knowing he is living, but not knowing where he is, in what conditions he is, maybe he is a slave, maybe he is being, you know, put to hardships. So these things, you know, they were bothering Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam very much. And due to this grief and sorrow, you know, he had lost his eyesight. He had became blind, practically blind, weeping and weeping and weeping. Because he knew he's alive. But where he is, and in what condition he is, don't know. إِنَّهُ لَذُو عِلْمٍ لِمَا عَلَّمْنَاهُ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But most of the people don't know.
وَلَمَّا دَخَلُوا عَلَى يُوسُفَ آوَى إِلَيْهِ أَخَاهُ قَالَ إِنِّي أَنَا أَخُوكَ فَلَا تَبْتَئِسْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ.
And when they entered upon Joseph, he took his brother to himself. He said, "Indeed, I am your brother, so do not despair over what they used to do to me."
وَلَمَّا دَخَلُوا عَلَىٰ يُوسُفَ آوَىٰ إِلَيْهِ أَخَاهُ. And when they entered on Yusuf, alayhi salatu wasalam, he called his brother to him privately. قَالَ إِنِّي أَنَا أَخُوكَ. And he said, "I am your brother. فَلَا تَبْتَئِسْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ." Now don't remain disheartened with what they have been doing. Those days are now gone. Because, you know, they must have been doing bad to this to Binyamin also, the character that they had. So he said, "Okay, I am your brother, and you will stay with me, and now your days of suffering are gone."
لما جهزهم بجهازهم جعل السقاية في رحل أخيه ثم أذن مؤذن أيتها العير إنكم لسارقون.
So when he had furnished them with their supplies, he put the gold measuring bowl into the bag of his brother. Then an announcer called out, "O caravan, indeed you are thieves."
فَلَمَّا جَهَّدَهُمْ بِجَهَازِهِمْ. Now then, when he has provided them with the provisions, جَعَلَ السِّقَايَةَ فِي رَحْلِ أَخِيهِ. Yusuf himself placed the drinking cup in his brother's saddle bag. Now the caravan was to depart. All the 11 brothers had to go, but Yusuf had placed himself, you know, a cup, and must be of gold. It was king's drinking cup. You know, he put it in the saddle bag of Benjamin. Summa azana muazzinun. Now the servants there, the boys working there, they didn't know. But anyone of them, he cried out, "Ayyatu halir innakum lasariqun. O cameliers, O people of the camels, you are thieves."
قالوا وأقبلوا عليهم ماذا تفقدون.
They said while approaching them, what is it you are missing?
قالوا وأقبلوا عليهم ماذا تفقدون. And they said, turning to them, what are you missing?
قالوا نفقد صواع الملك ولمن جاء به حمل بعير وأنا به زعيم.
They said, we are missing the measure of the king, and for he who produces it is the reward of a camel's load, and I am responsible for it.
قالوا نفقد صواع الملك. They said, we are missing the drinking cup of the king. وَلِمَنْ جَاءَ بِهِ حِمْلُ بَعِيرٍ Whosoever brings it back, well, we shall be punished. So actually, whosoever can bring us back, for him, حِمْلُ بَعِيرٍ another camel load of grain would be granted. وَأَنَا بِهِ زَعِيمٍ And I am responsible. I take the responsibility.
قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ عَلِمْتُمْ مَا جِئْنَا لِنُفْسِدَ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَمَا كُنَّا سَارِقِينَ
They said, By Allah, you have certainly known that we did not come to cause corruption in the land, and we have not been thieves.
قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ عَلِمْتُمْ مَا جِئْنَا لِنُفْسِدَ فِي الْأَرْضِ They said, By Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you very well know that we have not come here to make mischief in the land. وَمَا كُنَّا سَارِقِينَ And we are not thieves. We have come here to get the grain. How can we be thieves?
قَالُوا فَمَا جَزَاؤُهُ إِن كُنْتُمْ كَاذِبِينَ
The accuser said, Then what would be its recompense if you should be liars?
قَالُوا فَمَا جَزَاهُ إِن كُنْتُمْ كَاذِبِينَ They said, then what should be the punishment of the person if you are telling lie?
قَالُوا جَزَاؤُهُ مَنْ وُجِدَ فِي رَحْلِهِ فَهُوَ جَزَاؤُهُ كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الظَّالِمِينَ
The brothers said, its recompense is that he in whose bag it is found, he himself will be its recompense. Thus do we recompense the wrongdoers.
قَالُوا جَزَاهُ مَنْ وُجِدَ فِي رَحْلِهِ فَهُوَ جَزَاهُ They themselves said, okay, the person in whose sack this cup, drinking cup can be found, he himself will be the exchange of it. You can keep that person with you as a slave. كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْظَالِمِينَ And this is our method of punishing the thieves, the evildoers.
فَبَدَأَ بِأَوْعِيَتِهِمْ قَبْلَ وِعَاءِ أَخِيهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَخْرَجَهَا مِنْ وِعَاءِ أَخِيهِ كَذَلِكَ كِدْنَا لِيُوسُفِ ما كان ليأخذ أخاه في دين الملك إلا أن يشاء الله نرفع درجات من نشاء وفوق كل ذي علم عليم
So he began the search with their bags before the bag of his brother. Then he extracted it from the bag of his brother. Thus did we plan for Joseph. He could not have taken his brother within the religion of the king, except that Allah willed. We raise in degrees whom we will, but over every possessor of knowledge is one more knowing.
فَبَدَى بِأَوْعِيَتِهِمْ قَبْلَ وِعَاءِ أَخِيهِمْ Now Hazrat Yusuf a.s. began searching their sacks. And he searched the sacks of other brothers before the sack of his own brother, his real, total brother, his Aini brother, Binyamin. ثُمَّ اسْتَخْرَجَهَا مِنْ وِعَاءِ أَخِيهِ Then he took it out from the sack of his brother. كَذَلِكَ كِدْنَا لِيُوسُفْ Now this is an apology from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yusuf didn't do it on his own. It would have been sort of, you know, deceiving people. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him the permission. He had given him this way, shown him this way. And because this was, Allah knew, this is not going to do any harm to anybody. Even that this Binyamin, he will be saved of the torture, of the persecution of the brothers. He will remain here with the brother. He will be in comfort. And in the long run, Allah knew what beforehand what is going to happen. It will be not harmful for anybody. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, He commanded Yusuf to do this. Kavalika kidna le Yusuf. We contrived for Yusuf in this way. Ma kana le yakhud akhahu fi din al malik. It was not possible for him to retain his brother according to the law of the king. This ayah is one of the most important ayat to understand the meaning, essence, essential meaning of deen. Deen il malik. The system of governance in that land at that time was of monarchy. What is monarchy? One person holding the authority. Whatever he says becomes the law because he is sovereign. Now there was a law. Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam was occupying an authoritative position in that system, under that constitution. He was not himself the king. He was not the sovereign. Sovereign was the king who had seen that vision. And he had, you know, called back Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam from the prison and placed him at that position. He owed that position to the king. Now the laws were of the king, not of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam. So it was the system of governance in that country that was of monarchy. Now Deenul Malik, compare it with Deenullah. إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحُ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا. Deenul Malik, Deenullah. Deenul Awam, Deenul Malik, the system where sovereignty belongs to a person, king. Deenul Awam, democracy. A system where sovereignty belongs to the masses, popular sovereignty. Deenullah, a whole system of life where sovereignty belongs to Allah. So these three words you must keep in mind. What is deen? Deen is a whole system of life under some sovereignty. Sovereignty can be of a person. Sovereignty can be of the nation. And sovereignty can be of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is Deenullah. Islam is Deenullah. Inna deena indallahi al-Islam. That is Deenullah. And this is Deenul Jamhur. So to say, this is the Deen of Jamhur, the Deen of the masses. Because they have, theoretically speaking at least, they have their sovereignty. Ma kana li ya'khudh akhahu fi deenil malik illa an yasha Allah. Except if Allah commands, narfa'u darajatin man nasha'u, we raise in rank whomsoever we like. Wa fawqa kulli dhi ilmin aleem. And over every knowledgeable person, there is someone more knowledgeable. And above all knowing is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now what was the reaction? These people had not reformed themselves up till now. Even, you know, after the passage of so much time.
قَالُوا إِن يَسْرِقْ فَقَدْ سَرَقَ أَخٌ لَهُ مِنْ قَبْلِ فأسرها يوسف في نفسه ولم يبدها لهم قال أنتم شر مكانا والله أعلم بما تصفون.
They said, if he steals, a brother of his has stolen before. But Joseph kept it within himself and did not reveal it to them. He said, you are worse in position, and Allah is most knowing of what you describe.
قَالُوا إِن يَسْرِقْ فَقَدْ سَرَقَ أَخٌ لَهُ مِنْ قَبْلُ. Now if this Binyamin has committed a theft, a brother of his had also committed theft, you know, before. So they were blaming, you know, in addition to Binyamin, blaming Yusuf even. فَأَسَرَّهَا يُوسُفُ فِي نَفْسِهِ. So, but Yusuf kept it hidden in his heart. He didn't retort. But he said in heart, وَلَمْ يُبْدِهَا لَهُمْ. He didn't say so openly to them. He said so in his heart, قَالَ أَلْتُمْ شَرٌ مَكَانًا. You are worst in this status, in this position. وَاللَّهُ عَلَمُ مِمَا تَصِفُونَ. Allah very well knows what you are saying. You are absolutely giving a false accusation against me. No, I know that I never committed a theft. And you are saying that his brother also committed a theft. If he committed a theft, It's nothing, you know, unexpected, because his brother also committed a theft. So they were still, you know, at that low level of meanness.
قَالُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الْعَزِيزُ إِنَّ لَهُ أَبًا شَيْخًا كَبِيرًا فَخُذْ أَحَدَنَا مَكَانَهُ إِنَّا نَرَاكَ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ
They said, O Aziz, indeed he has a father who is an old man, so take one of us in place of him. Indeed, we see you as a doer of good.
قَالُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الْعَزِيزُ إِنَّ لَهُ أَبًا شَيْخًا كَبِيرًا They said, O Aziz, he has a father and he is very old. شَيْخًا كَبِيرًا فَخُذْ أَحَدَنَا مَكَانَهُ You keep any one of us in his place. إِنَّا نَرَاكَ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ We see you that you are a good doer. You behave with people gently. So please accept our request that you detain him. If he committed the theft, according to what we said, he can be detained here. But please don't detain him. Any one of us you like, detain him.
قال معاذ الله أن نأخذ إلا من وجدنا متاعنا عنده إنا إذا لظالمون
He said, I seek the refuge of Allah to prevent that we take except him with whom we found our possession. Indeed, we would then be unjust.
قال معاذ الله أن نأخذ إلا من وجدنا متاعنا عنده إِنَّا إِذَا لَظَالِمُونَ He said, well, we take refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we should seize a person, except one in whose sake we found our material, our property. If we do this, well, we shall be evil doers. He has done it by Allah's permission to retain Hazrat Ibn Yamin.
فلما استيأسوا منه خلصوا نجيا قال كبيرهم ألم تعلموا أن أباكم قد أخذ عليكم موثقا من الله ومن قبل ما فرطتم في يوسف فَلَنْ أَبْرَحَ الْأَرْضَ حَتَّى يَأْذَنَ لِي أَبِي أَوْ يَحْكُمَ اللَّهُ لِي وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الْحَاكِمِينَ
So when they had despaired of him, they secluded themselves in private consultation. The eldest of them said, Do you not know that your father has taken upon you an oath by Allah, and that before you failed in your duty to Joseph? So I will never leave this land until my father permits me, or Allah decides for me. And he is the best of judges.
فَلَمَّا اسْتَيْأَسُوا مِنْهُ When they were disappointed from him that he is not going to let Benjamin go now. خَلَصُوا نَجِيَّا Now they conferred and they consulted each other privately. قَالَ كَبِيرُهُمْ The eldest of them said, أَلَمْ تَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ أَبَاكُمْ قَدْ أَخَذَ عَلَيْكُمْ مَوْثِقًا مِنَ اللَّهِ Don't you remember? Your father got from you a solemn pledge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمِنْ قَبْلُ مَا فَرَّطْتُمْ فِي يُوسُفْ And just remember what excesses you did to Yusuf before. He was, you know, the eldest and the kindest among them. He is the one who said, لَا تَقْتُلُوا يُوسُفَ If you are bent upon doing something to him, well, throw him in some well so that he doesn't die. No, some caravan should come and take him out and take him away from you. If you are bent upon doing something, but don't kill him. And the same now he is blaming them. مَا فَرَّطُمْ فِي يُوسُفَ فَلَنْ أَبْرَحَ اللَّهُ I am not going to depart from this land حَتَّى يَعْذَنَ لِي أَبِي until and unless my father gives me an express permission. أَوْ يَحْكُمَ اللَّهُ لِي Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides something else for me. Maybe he sends death to me in this land, but I am not going to face my father without Benjamin. وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الْحَاكِمِينَ And surely Allah is the best of the judges.
ارْجِعُوا إِلَىٰ أبيكم فقولوا يا أبانا إن ابنك سرق وما شهدنا إلا بما علمنا وَمَا شَهِدْنَا إِلَّا بِمَا عَلِمْنَا وَمَا كُنَّا لِلْغَيْبِ حَافِظِينَ
Return to your father and say, O our father, indeed your son has stolen, and we did not testify except to what we knew, and we were not witnesses of the unseen.
اِرْجُعُوا إِلَىٰ أَبِيكُمْ Now you go back to your father. ارجو الى ابيكم فقولوا يا ابانا and tell him oh our father in ابنك سرق verily your son committed a theft وما شهدنا الا ما علمنا and we can't give any testimony except what we have come to know we can't say whether it is correct or wrong but these are the facts of the case وما كنا للغيب حافظين but we are not guardians over the unseen What has actually happened, we don't know.
وَاسْأَلِ الْقَرْيَةَ الَّتِي كُنَّا فِيهَا وَالْعِيرَ الَّتِي أَقْبَلْنَا فِيهَا وَإِنَّا لَصَادِقُونَ
And ask the city in which we were and the caravan in which we came, and indeed we are truthful.
وَاسْأَلِ الْقَرْيَةَ الَّتِي كُنَّا فِيهَا You can ask the town in which we were. وَالْعِيرَ الَّتِي أَقْبَلْنَا فِيهَا You ask the caravan, the people in the caravan with which we have returned. إِنَّا لَصَادِقُونَ Whatever we are saying is true.
قَالَ بَلْ سَوَّلَتْ لَكُمْ أَنفُسُكُمْ أَمْرًا فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ عَسَى اللَّهُ أَن يَأْتِيَنِي بِهِمْ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ
Jacob said, Rather, your souls have enticed you to something, so patience is most fitting. Perhaps Allah will bring them to me all together. Indeed, it is He who is the knowing, the wise.
قَالَ بَلْ سَوَّلَتْ لَكُمْ أَنفُسُكُمْ أَمْرًا حضرت یعقوب said the same words Your minds have enticed you to invent the matter فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ Again, I will have patience and in a beautiful way أَصَى اللَّهُ أَنْ يَعْتِيَنِي بِهِمْ جَمِيعًا This he knew Yusuf is also alive أَصَى اللَّهُ I hope It's just possible that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings to me both of them together إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ Verily, he is all-knowing, all-wise.
وَتَوَلَّى عَنْهُمْ وَقَالَ يَا أَسَفَى عَلَى يُوسُفَ وَابْيَضَّتْ عَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْحُزْنِ فَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ
And he turned away from them and said, O my sorrow over Joseph! And his eyes became white from grief, for he was of that a suppressor.
وَتَوَلَّى عَنْهُمْ And he just turned away from them. وَقَالَ يَا أَسَفَى عَلَى يُوسُفَ And he said, Alas, oh my grief for Yusuf. Note here. Again he is lamenting for Yusuf. Although the fresh, you know, shock was for Binyamin. But the love for Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam was so much, you know, deep in the heart of Hazrat Yaqub that even here he is mentioning Yusuf. يَا أَسَفَى عَلَى يُوسُفَ وَبْيَضَّتْ عَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْحُزْنِ And due to the grief, his eyes had become white. Huwa kazim, and he was, you know, withholding and choking within him the grief.
قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ تَفْتَأُ تَذْكُرُ يُوسُفَ حَتَّى تَكُونَ حَرَضًا أَوْ تَكُونَ مِنَ الْهَالِكِينَ
They said, by Allah, You will not cease remembering Joseph until you become fatally ill or become of those who perish.
قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ تَفْتَأُ تَذْكُرُ يُوسُفَ حَتَّى تَكُونَ حَرَضًا أَوْ تَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُهْلِكِينَ They said, by Allah, you will not cease remembering Yusuf till you become exhausted or you become dead.
قال إنما أشكو بثي وحزني إلى الله وأعلم من الله ما لا تعلمون.
He said, I only complain of my suffering and my grief to Allah, and I know from Allah that which you do not know.
قال إنما أشكو بثي وحزني إلى الله. He said, I am complaining of my grief and sorrow only to Allah. I am saying nothing to you. Why do you stop me? إِنَّمَا أَشْكُوا بَسِّي وَحُزْنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَالَمُ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. I know from Allah what you don't know. I know that Yusuf is alive. I know that he will come to me again. And that is why, you know, I have all this grief.
يَا بَنِي يَذْهَبُوا فَتَحَسَّسُوا مِن يُوسُفَ وَأَخِيهِ وَلَا تَيْأَسُوا مِن رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِنَّهُ لَا يَيْأَسُ مِن رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْكَافِرُونَ.
O my sons, go and find out about Joseph and his brother, and despair not of relief from Allah. Indeed, no one despairs of relief from Allah except the disbelieving people.
Ya baniya izhabu fatahassasu min Yusuf wa akhihi. O my sons, go and search for Yusuf and his brother. Wala tayasu min rahillah. Don't despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Innahu la yayasu min rahillah illa al-qawmul kafirun. Verily, only the people who disbelieve, they become despaired and disappointed from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
فَلَمَّا دَخَلُوا عَلَيْهِ قَالُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الْعَزِيزُ مَسَّنَا وَأَهْلَنَا الضُّرُّ وَجِئْنَا بِبِضَاعَةٍ مُزْجَاةٍ فَأَوْفِ لَنَا الْكَيْلَ وَتَصَدَّقْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَجْزِي الْمُتَصَدِّقِينَ.
So when they entered upon Joseph, they said, O Aziz, adversity has touched us and our family, and we have come with goods poor in quality, but give us full measure and be charitable to us. Indeed, Allah rewards the charitable.
فَلَمَّا دَخَلُوا عَلَيْهِ قَالُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الْعَزِيزِ. Now it's a very pitiable position. Now when they came and they presented themselves to Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, قَالُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الْعَزِيزِ. They said, O you Aziz, O you powerful, O you holding the authority, مَسَّنَا وَأَهْلَنَا الضُّرِّ. Affliction has touched us and our families. وَجَيْنَا بِبِزَاعَةٍ مُزْجَاةٍ. And we have brought the merchandise which is of scant worth, no value. Now we have been left with nothing. We can't present anything in exchange. Very little we have to offer as a price for this ration. فَأَوْفِ لَنَا الْكَيْلَ. But you please give us full measures. Don't look to what we have to offer. You please give us the full measures. وَتَصَدَّقَ لَنَا. And be charitable to us. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَجْزِي الْمُتَصَدِّقِينَ. Verily Allah rewards the one who makes charity.
قَالَ هَلْ عَلِمْتُمْ مَا فَعَلْتُمْ بِيُوسُفَ وَأَخِيهِ إِذْ أَنْتُمْ جَاهِلُونَ.
He said, do you know what you did with Joseph and his brother when you were ignorant?
قَالَ هَلْ عَلِمْتُمْ. Now this was the time to disclose. He couldn't wait anymore. He couldn't see the plight of the brothers. They had gone so, you know, low now. And the condition was so pitiable for Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam to bear anymore. So he disclosed himself. قَالَ هَلْ عَلِمْتُمْ مَا فَعَلْتُمْ بِيُوسُفَ وَأَخِيهِ إِذْ أَنْتُمْ جَاهِلُونَ. He said, do you recall and remember what you did to Yusuf and his brother when you were ignorant? As if they were not ignorant now. They were ignorant even now, but because, you know, he was a gentle person. He didn't want to say that in the face of his brothers.
قَالُوا أَإِنَّكَ لَأَنْتَ يُوسُفُ. قَالَ أَنَا يُوسُفُ وَهَذَا أَخِي. قَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا. إنه من يتق ويصبر فإن الله لا يضيع أجر المحسنين.
They said, "Are you indeed Joseph?" He said, "I am Joseph, and this is my brother. Allah has certainly favored us. Indeed, he who fears Allah and is patient, then indeed Allah does not allow to be lost the reward of those who do good."
قَالُوا أَيْنَّكَ لَأَنْتَ يُوسُفْ. Now they say, "Oh, are you indeed Yusuf?" قَالَ أَنَا يُوسُفْ وَهَذَا أَخِي. He said, "Yes, I'm Yusuf and he's my brother, Benjamin. قَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا. Our Lord has been very gracious upon me, us. إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَتَّقِي وَيَسْبِرْ. Verily, whosoever has taqwa and regards, proper regard for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remains mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and shows perseverance, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَزِيُّ عَلِيُّ الْمُحْسَنِينَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't let the reward of these muhsaneen go in waste.
قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ آثَرَكَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا وَإِن كُنَّا لَخَاطِئِينَ.
They said, "By Allah, certainly has Allah preferred you over us, and indeed we have been sinners."
قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ آثَرَكَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا وَإِن كُنَّا لَخَاطِئِينَ. They said, "By God, we swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has indeed chosen you above us. And this is the choice for prophethood. They were all sons of Yaqub. Someone has to be chosen. And you know, it was proved for all of them that actually Yusuf deserves to be chosen. And certainly we have been sinners."
قَالَ لَا تَثْرِيبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْيَوْمِ يَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَهُوَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ.
He said, "No blame will there be upon you today. Allah will forgive you, and He is the most merciful of the merciful."
قَالَ لَا تَثْرِيبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْيَوْمِ. He said, "No, there's going to be no reproach upon you this day. يَغْفَرُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. I pray to Allah, He may forgive you. وَهُوَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. And He is the most merciful of all the merciful."
اذْهَبُوا بِقَمِيصِي هَذَا فَأَلْقُوهُ عَلَى وَجْهِ أَبِي يَأْتِ بَصِيرًا وَأْتُونِي بِأَهْلِكُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ.
Take this, my shirt, and cast it over the face of my father. He will become seeing. And bring me your family, all together.
اذهبوا بقميصي هذا. Now take this shirt of mine and go with it. Take with you this shirt of mine. فالقوه على وجه أبي. And put it and cast it over the face of my father. يأتي بصيرا. His sight will return. واتوني بأهلكم أجمعين. And then you bring all your family and bring them to me here.
وَلَمَّا فَصَلَتِ الْعِيرُ قَالَ أَبُوهُمْ إِنِّي لَأَجِدُ رِيحَ يُوسُفَ لَوْلَا أَن تُفَنِّدُونَ.
And when the caravan departed from Egypt, their father said, "Indeed, I find the smell of Joseph and would say that he was alive if you did not think me weakened in mind."
Now when that caravan now left Egypt with that shirt of Hazrat Yusuf, قَالَ أَبُوهُمْ. And now in Canaan, Hazrat Yaqub, their father said, إِنِّي لَأَجِدُ رُوِيحَ يُوسُفْ. I find and I feel, I perceive the scent of Yusuf. لَوْلَا أَن تُفَنِّدُونَ. Only if you don't think that I have been demenciated due to old age, you know. So I have gone crazy, demenciated. But you know, I am feeling and perceiving the scent of Yusuf.
قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ إِنَّكَ لَفِي ضَلَالِكَ الْقَدِيمِ.
They said, "By Allah, indeed you are in your same old error."
قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ إِنَّكَ لَفِي ضَلَالِكَ الْقَدِيمِ. They said, "Oh, verily, by Allah, you are in your error, your old error. You think that he is alive. He has gone, you know, long away."
فَلَمَّا أَنْ جاء البشير ألقاه على وجهه فارتد بصيرا قال ألم أقل لكم إني أعلم من الله ما لا تعلمون.
And when the bearer of good tidings arrived, he cast it over his face, and he returned once again seeing. He said, Did I not tell you that I know from Allah that which you do not know?
فَلَمَّا أَنْجَاءَ الْبَشِيرُ أَلْقَاهُ عَلَىٰ وَجْهِهِ فَارْتَدَّ بَصِيرًا. Now when the bearer of the glad tidings came and he cast the shirt of Yusuf on his face, he became, again seeing. قَالَ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ لَكُمْ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. He said, didn't I say to them that I know from Allah what you don't know?
قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا اسْتَغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا خَاطِئِينَ.
They said, O our Father, ask for us forgiveness of our sins. Indeed, we have been sinners.
قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا اسْتَغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا. They said, O our Father, now ask forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us. For our sins, inna kunna qati'in, verily we were the sinners.
قَالَ سَوْفَ أَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ رَبِّي إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ.
He said, I will ask forgiveness for you from my Lord. Indeed, it is He who is the forgiving, the merciful.
قَالَ سَوْفَ أَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ. Now here Lord Sofa. No, he didn't ask the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala there and then, at the same time, immediately. He just promised, okay, after some time. So far is for future. I will do it, okay. But he was angry. So immediately he didn't ask the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So far, astaghfiru lakum, Rabbi. Okay, I will ask the forgiveness of my Lord for you. Innahu wal ghafur rahim, verily he is merciful and he is forgiving.
فَلَمَّا دَخَلُوا عَلَى يُوسُفَ آوَى إِلَيْهِ أَبَوَيْهِ وَقَالَ ادْخُلُوا مِصْرَ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ آمِنِينَ.
And when they entered upon Joseph, he took his parents to himself and said, Enter Egypt, Allah willing, safe and secure.
فَلَمَّا دَخَلُوا عَلَى يُوسُفَ آوَى إِلَيْهِ أَبَوَيْهِ. Now when all of them entered Egypt, and when they presented themselves to Yusuf, he raised his parents, father and mother, to his throne. وَقَالَ ادْخُلُوا مِصْرَ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ آمِنِينَ. And he welcomed them. Now enter Misr. If Allah so decrees, you will have peace here. You will have all rest, security. Now note this also point of political importance. Because the king was not an Egyptian, alien king, so that was also advisable for him to have some alien force over there. So he actually welcomed and he settled them down in the best areas of Egypt. The best, the most fertile lands were given to them. Okay, come here, settle. So that he has a force, If there is some rebellion, uprising among the locals, then he can have a support. And that is why, these people, Bani Israel, their progeny, they enjoyed the best of comforts. They were the most, fortunate people. They had the best lands. And they had all the support of that king and his family. And that is why they were very prosperous. They multiplied in number. ادخلوا مصر إن شاء الله آمنين.
رفع أبويه على العرش وخروا له سجدا وقال يا أبت هذا تأويل رؤياي من قبل قد جعلها ربي حقا وَقَدْ أَحْسَنَ بِي إِذْ أَخْرَجَنِي مِنَ السِّجْنِ وَجَاءَ بِكُمْ مِنَ الْبَدْوِ مِنْ بَعْدِ أَنْ نزغ الشيطان من بعد أن نزغ الشيطان بيني وبين إخوتي إن ربي لطيف لما يشاء إنه هو العليم الحكيم.
And he raised his parents upon the throne, and they bowed to him in prostration. And he said, O my father, this is the explanation of my vision of before. My Lord has made it reality, and he was certainly good to me when he took me out of prison and brought you here from Bedouin life after Satan had induced estrangement between me and my brothers. Indeed, my Lord is subtle in what he wills. Indeed, it is he who is the knowing, the wise.
But there was, after a few hundred years, there was a local revolt, a revolution. Then the sons of the soil came up. Now for them, these people were the worst people, because they had supported and they were a source of support for those alien rulers who were not Egyptians originally, who were alien rulers for Egyptians. And he raised both his parents on the throne, and they prostrated before, fallen, they fell before him in prostration. And Yusuf said, Oh, my father, this is the ta'wil, this is the end, and this is the interpretation of my dream that I saw much earlier. قَدْ جَعَلَهَا رَبِّي حَقَّا My Lord, my Rabb, has made it true. وَقَدْ أَحْسَنَ بِي إِذْ أَخْرَجَنِي مِنَ السِّجْنِ And he was very gracious to me when he brought me forth from the prison. وَجَعَ بِكُمْ مِنَ الْبَذْرِ And in the same way, he is very gracious that he has brought you from that desert. وَمِنْ بَعْدِ أَنْ نَذَغَ الشَّيْطَانُ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ إِخْوَتِي After the Satan had inflicted a strife between me and my brothers. Inna Rabbi Latifun Lima Yasha. My Lord is very subtle to whatever He commands and whatever He wants. Whatever He wants to accomplish, nobody can, obstruct Him. Innahu huwa al-alimul hakeem. Verily, He is the all-knowing, all-wise.
Rabbi qad aataytani min al-mulki wa'allamtani min ta'wili al-ahadith. فاطر السماوات والأرض أنت ولي في الدنيا والآخرة توفني مسلما وألحقني بالصالحين
My Lord, you have given me something of sovereignty and taught me of the interpretation of dreams. Creator of the heavens and earth, you are my protector in this world and the hereafter. Cause me to die a Muslim and join me with the righteous.
رَبِّ قَدْ آتَيْتَنِي مِنَ الْمُلْكِ Now he is praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. O my Lord, you have given me this power to rule the land. وَعَلَّمْتَنِي مِنْ تَعْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ And it is you who taught me the interpretation of all things, all sayings, all visions, all incidents, all accidents. فَاطِرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ O the originator of the heavens and the earth. أَنْتَ وَلِيِّ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ You are my protector, even in this world and also in the hereafter. تَوَفَّنِي مُسْلِمًا So please make me die as a Muslim. Protect me that I don't go away or go back from Islam and Iman. Keep me a Muslim till my death. وَالْحِقْنِي بِالصَّالِحِينَ And then you join me with your righteous persons, bondsmen.
ذلك من أنباء الغيب نوحيه إليك وما كنت لديهم إذ أجمعوا أمرهم وهم يمكرون
That is from the news of the unseen which we reveal, O Muhammad, to you. And you were not with them when they put together their plan while they conspired.
ذَلِكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الْغَيْبِ نُوحِي إِلَيْكَ. Now this is from the news of the unseen that we are relating to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are revealing to you. وَمَا كُنْتَ لَدَيْهِمْ. You were not with them. إِذْ أَجْمَعُوا أَمْرَهُمْ. When they had decided and agreed upon their plot to put Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam into the well. وَهُمْ يَمْكُرُونَ. And they were, you know, plotting.
وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ.
And most of the people, although you strive for it, are not believers.
وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. Although, you know, for these people who ask this question, this should suffice. This should be sufficient for them to reveal to them that Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah. And all these news are coming to him from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It should be sufficient. وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. But even if you are very desirous, very keen, most of the people will not come to believe.
وَمَا تَسْأَلُهُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرٍ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرٌ لِلْعَالَمِينَ.
And you do not ask of them for it any payment. It is not except a reminder to the worlds.
وَمَا تَسْأَلُهُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرٍ. And you are not asking for them any reward. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرٌ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. It is nothing but a reminding for all the worlds, all the nations of the world.
وَكَأَيِّمْ مِنْ آيَةٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يَمُرُّونَ عَلَيْهَا وَهُمْ عَنْهَا مُعْرِضُونَ.
And how many a sign within the heavens and earth do they pass over while they therefrom are turning away?
وَكَأَيِّمْ مِنْ آيَةٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يَمُرُّونَ عَلَيْهَا وَهُمْ عَنْهَا مُعْرِضُونَ. And how many signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His unity, His attributes are there in the heavens and the earth, and they pass over them, pass by them. وَهُمْ عَنْهَا مُعْرِضُونَ. But they don't ponder over them. They turn their faces away from them.
وَمَا يُؤْمِنُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ.
And most of them believe not in Allah except while they associate others with Him.
وَمَا يُؤْمِنُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ. Another very great, very important ayah. And most of them don't believe in Allah except doing some sort of shirk also. This is applicable to us also. If we, you know, peep down into our hearts and what beliefs we have, and to our, if we interpret, you know, what our actions are, we'll find that we are also committing shirk. But only we have to know what shapes and what forms this shirk can take. What was the shirk of the ancient time? What is the shirk of the modern time? I have a 2 hours recording on this subject, the forms of shirk, different forms of shirk.
أَفَأَمِنُوا أَن تَأْتِيَهُمْ غَاشِيَةٌ مِّنْ عَذَابِ اللَّهِ أَوْ تَأْتِيَهُمُ السَّاعَةُ بَغْتَةً وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ.
Then do they feel secure that there will not come to them an overwhelming aspect of the punishment of Allah, or that the hour will not come upon them suddenly while they do not perceive?
أَفَأَمِنُوا أَن يَأْتِيَهُمْ غَاشِيَةٌ مِّنْ عَذَابِ اللَّهِ. Are these people secure that to them cannot come a covering from the chastisement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? أَوْ تَعْتِيَهُمْ السَّاعَةُ. Or to him, the appointed hour, that qiyamah, might come baghtatan, suddenly. وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. They will not be perceiving it. They will not be apprehending it.
قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُو إِلَى اللَّهِ على بصيرة أنا ومن اتبعني وسبحان الله وما أنا من المشركين.
Say, this is my way. I invite to Allah with insight, I and those who follow me. And exalted is Allah, and I am not of those who associate others with Him.
قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَىٰ بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي. Say to them, this is my way. I'm calling towards Allah, and I'm calling not blindly, with sure knowledge. This is most important. هذه سبيلي ادعو الى الله على بصيره انا ومن اتبعني not only me also who are following me they are not following blindly they are following knowingly but subhanallah wa ma ana min al mushrikeen and all glory is for allah and I am not an associated I am not from among the associated I don't associate anyone anything with allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in any respect
ما ارسلنا من قبلك الا رجالا نوحي اليهم من اهل القرى افلم يسيروا في الارض فينظروا كيف كان عاقبه الذين من قبلهم ولدار الآخرة خير للذين اتقوا أفلا تعقلون
And we sent not before you as messengers except men to whom we revealed from among the people of cities. So have they not traveled through the earth and observed how was the end of those before them? And the home of the hereafter is best for those who fear Allah. Then will you not reason?
وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ إِلَّا رِجَالًا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِمْ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْقُرَىٰ And we didn't send before you to all these towns messengers, but they were men. They were humans. أَلَمْ يَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ Have they not moved in the earth, in the land, traveled in the land? فَيَنْظُرُوا كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ And see for themselves what was the end of those who were before them. وَلَدَارُ الْآخِرَةِ خَيْرٌ لِلَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا And surely, The house of hereafter is much better for those who have taqwa, who believe in Allah, who regard Him. أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ So don't you understand?
حَتَّى إِذَا اسْتَيْأَسَ الرُّسُلُ وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُمْ قَدْ كُذِبُوا جَاءَهُمْ نَصْرُنَا فَنُجِّيَ مَنْ نَشَاءَ وَلَا يُرَدُّ بَأْسُنَا عَنِ الْقَوْمِ الْمُجْرِمِينَ
They continued until, when the messengers despaired and were certain that they had been denied, there came to them our victory, and whoever we willed was saved. And our punishment cannot be repelled from the people who are criminals.
حَتَّى إِذَا اسْتَيْأَسَ الرُّسُلُ Until when the messengers got despaired. Despaired of what? Not of Allah's help, but that the nation is not going to believe anymore. No one else is going to believe now from among them. This is what you know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we have read it in Surah Uhud, that, O Nuh, nobody else is now going to believe in you, except those who have already believed. حَتَّى إِذَا اسْتَيْأَسَ الرُّسُلُ When the messengers of Allah became despaired of the people that they are not going to believe, وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُمْ قَدْ كُذِبُوا And people also thought that they were told lies when they were told that a chastisement will come, a azab will come, you will be destroyed, and so many years have passed, no azab has come, and he thought also that all it was lie, it was false, threats, nothing else. Jaahum nafrona. Then our help came to them, to the messengers. Fanujiya man nasha. So whomsoever we please, he was saved. وَلَا يُرَدُّ بَأْسُنَا عَنِ الْقَوْمِ الْمُجْرِمِينَ And our chastisement could not be averted. Our wrath could not be averted from the guilty.
قَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى وَلَكِنْ تصديق الذي بين يديه وتفصيل كل شيء وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون
There was certainly in their stories a lesson for those of understanding. Never was the Quran a narration invented. But a confirmation of what was before it, and a detailed explanation of all things, and guidance and mercy for a people who believe.